All right, I'll just keep looking like this then.
He's bionic.
That's my lobotomy. You can look. You can look right through my head, folks. Looky here. Oh, ho, ho.
What do you say?
Have a good show, Red Eye.
Downtown Miami and the bright sunshine, 80 degrees it is. The Orange Bowl is packed. Roger Staubach will quarterback the Dallas Cowboys. He is number 12, of course. Number 12 for the Miami Dolphins, the host team wearing glasses, Bob Greasy. And what do they say? If you want to start a franchise, Thomas?
Come to Miami.
And pick Bob Greasy to be your quarterback. They are entertaining today the Dallas quarterback, Dallas Cowboys. And a good afternoon to you from Miami. I'm Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire. They say you can pass against Dallas and you can run against Miami. Do you agree?
Well, I think Bob Greasy can pass against anybody. We were talking to some people before the game, and they said if you want to start a team with an unselfish quarterback that is superb at play action passing and running, if that's what the game calls for, it's Bob Greasy. And he is healthy, and he's back from that knee surgery.
We have two of the most exciting runners, I guess, in professional football, and Delvin Williams for the Dolphins and Tony Dorsett for Dallas.
Delvin Williams will be running against the Dallas team, though. You and I have seen very few teams live by the run against the Cowboys. Pittsburgh a year ago, and I can't think of anybody before that. I think they've got to throw the football to Nat Moore and Duriel Harris.
What about Dorsett?
Well, they say Dorsett is the time bomb. That's the one that Shula's worried about, that if he has his big day here with a nationally televised football game, Dorsett can turn the football game around. He is that good.
Okay, Tom, let's go down and see what's happening on the field with the flip of the coin going on right now. The Miami captains, you see. And Miami has won the toss. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire at the Orange Bowl in Miami. Flipper the second is in that 37,000-gallon tank.
That's either a dolphin or a porpoise. We don't want Jacques Cousteau to call in and act like we're dummies, you know. I wanted to clarify that.
The dolphin. He is 20 years old. I'm sorry, Tom.
That's true.
That's the Dolphin that's 20 years old.
The Dolphin football team that we're watching right now in their huddle with Don Shula is stolen the football. They blocked punts. And, of course, then they got their quarterback back, Bob Greasy, for two quarters against San Diego and the whole game against New England. He is ready to go.
Today's officials, the referee is Gordon McCarter, Tony Kramer, Jerry Seaman, Jack Fetty, Ray Douglas, Bill Quinby, and Armin Terzian will be the rest of his staff. It'll be Rafael Septien to kick off for Dallas, and that, of course, the jet-jawed profile of Don Shula.
I think about the best coach to work with whatever his talent might be in a given year, maybe in all of football. I think he does a heck of a job with whatever there is on the field.
There is Septien. And on the other side of the field, speaking of those who work well with what they have, is Tom Landry, the Cowboy head coach. Deep for Miami, by the way, will be Duriel Harris in the middle. He's the guy they'd like to handle it, number 82. Jimmy Cephalo on one side and Gary Davis on the other side.
Cephalo's a dangerous young man, the rookie from Penn State.
And so is Harris, who's standing in the shadows in his own goal line. A beautiful, bright, sunshiny day in Miami. Temperature around 80 degrees right now. The line shot from Septien will be handled a yard deep in the end zone by Harris. With a wedge in front. Duriel Harris has got some room. He's got the speed, and Rafael Septien made the first contact. Dennis Thurman got him out of bounds.
Tell you, Septien makes a heck of a play. Number one went over like he really was going to be aggressive. It's a good thing he did. He made him run laterally.
We will set the Dallas defense when we have a chance, as well as the Miami offense. We'll watch the Miami Dolphins with their record of 6-3. Here is the Dallas defensive line.
Randy White in the middle there has had 9 sacks in the last 5 games for the Cowboys. They've got to come to his level.
Those are the linebackers, good ones, and that's the secondary. Mark Washington, though, is starting in place of Benny Barnes, number 46 in the corner. Let's see if the Dolphins throw on first down. Pulak. And here they come throwing. Here he comes open. That's Duriel Harris. Aaron Kyle, the tackler.
This young man has tremendous speed. He's only 5'11" tall. Watch Greasy's protection. Keep in mind the offensive line, Langer, Kuchenberg, and company. We'll tell you about them in a moment. A good turn-in pattern, and he had a lot of time to throw it.
Most people have come to believe that the time to throw against this Cowboy flex defense is on first down. Greasy again with Fulach and Delvin Williams, the setbacks. And this is Williams. Thomas Henderson, the tackler, he got about four.
That's where Delvin Williams lives. Now, he's averaging 5.1 a shot, and the offensive line might be the best blocking line for the rushing the football in the whole league right now, Patrick.
That is the offensive line, the All-Pro Jim Langer at center, the All-Pro Larry Little at one guard. Bob Kuchenberg has moved out to tackle.
Look at these receivers, Moore and Harris, and dangerous, and Tillman's fast improving the tight end.
That's the backfield now, and it's Fulach. At fullback, Delvin Williams, the other back, and Greasy drops. Williams, the receiver, breaks two tackles and could go. Does a change of pace by Charlie Waters, but he finally makes the tackle inside the 10. Just inside the 10.
That's the 12th reception for Delvin Williams, and no longer is there any doubt about the trade with San Francisco. Watch the play. Again, Greasy goes sidearm. Watch Greasy drop his arm down to throw it by somebody. Missed tackle here. Two linebackers knock one another off. And you better get it all lined up now to catch him.
Brunick and Henderson were the two Dallas linebackers. They marked the ball at the 11, where it'll be first and 10 Dolphins. Looking to strike quickly, and Greasy asks for quiet. Sellout crowd. The earliest they've had since 1974 here. Real Harris, good pattern. Slipped at about the 3. Aaron Kyle got him out of bounds, but he gets down to the 1.
All right, this is Harris's 28th catch of the year. A quick turnout. Again, Greasy loads it up. Two little steps. Bam. There's no time to put a rush on him.
Greasy is 3 for 3.
And remember, you cannot bump those receivers after they get past that 5-yard area. And down close, it's tough.
They'll measure for a first down.
Greasy sets up so fast, trims the fat away from plays and makes them very basic, Pat. I can see how the defensive must drive you nuts.
Almost impossible to rush him. Dolphin first down. Dallas record is 6-3, so is Miami. The Dolphins look sharp, don't they?
A lot of Cowboys are talking to themselves. I see a lot of people pointing at one another.
Well, that's a bad sign.
I've done that before. I know what they're doing.
I thought you had him. No, he's your man. First and goal, Dolphins. That much they need. Williams. Not this time. Thomas Henderson made the initial hit.
Williams only goes about 196 pounds, Pat. He is extremely strong. I'm surprised we haven't seen Braxton come in, the big 245-pound fullback for the Dolphins. You can see he did not get it.
Starting Fulach would indicate, I think you'd agree, that they intend to put the ball in the air. Fulach is an excellent receiver out of the backfield. It'll be second down and about 2 feet perhaps. No score with 12:04 left to play first quarter. But the Dolphins are down there.
Norm Fulach's first touchdown of the year. Larry Zonka used to run that left side. It's a straight play by the fullback.
What a sight that is.
That's Langer, Kuchenberg to the top. You can see that Newman pulled through the hole, and they had a big hole in that goal line defense.
Garrow Yeprimian with Don Strock holding. We'll try to make it 7-0, Miami. 73 yards and 6 plays. End the Flippers tank. So, with 11:55 left to play in the first quarter, the Dolphins drove it for the first touchdown of the game.
Can he load
that
it up and get it out of
there? Huh?
Can he load it up?
Yeah. And quick, like you say.
Sandy? You know, you usually don't, a lot of people tell you you can't trap down close. Inside the two or three, a lot of people don't believe it. They cross block there. Man, I mean, they.
That's a good looking drive.
We haven't even seen Staubach yet, and it's 7-0. We haven't seen Roger yet at all. Offense hadn't been on the field. See what kind of a first quarter team they are.
I was just looking at that just before.
They have a pretty good first half.
Gary Pimerian will kick it off. The 80-degree weather at the Orange Bowl in Miami. Lewis Blackwell comes outside the 30. A flag is down. Those of you who watched the St. Louis Cardinals defeat the New York Giants 20-10 to get their second victory of the year, welcome to our broadcast. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire at the Orange Bowl in Miami, where the Dolphins took the opening kickoff, drove 73 yards, and got the first touchdown of this contest. They lead it 7-0. Norm Boulash scored from about 2 feet out.
You know, mistakes like this early in the game when you're trailing 7-0 and Staubach has not called a play yet, that's got to deflate you a little bit.
Personal foul. Number 59 receivers during the return.
Guy Brown is number 59.
Watch number 64, Newman, pull to the left, cross blocking. Big tackle in there, Kuchenberg. That's a big hole for a goal line.
They say you can't do that close to the goal line. But you can, can't you? Dorsetta Newhouse behind Roger Staubach. And Newhouse tries to get away from a couple of tackles, but can't. Steve Cole and Larry Gordon, two of the linebackers for the Dolphins. There's Don Shula with his back to the play, but just for a moment.
The man that went to the 35 defense, Chuck Fairbanks up in New England, said that in one film they watched of the Dolphin defense, they were in more fronts than they've seen an entire season watching films of other defenses.
Just little subtle changes.
In the gap a little bit instead of being on the nose, but they play it pretty tough.
Dorsetta Newhouse, it'll be second 11. Newhouse will make it 12. Newhouse lost two on first down. Drew Pearson left the backfield in motion, and Dorsett, they hit it the line of scrimmage. Fumble. Whoa. The Dolphins have it.
Dorsett's eighth fumble of the year. A very uncharacteristic thing for the Cowboys. Their 12th fumble and the eighth by number 33. That was Den Herter, the big defensive end.
Den Herter hit him in the backfield, knocked it loose. Bob Matheson came up with the fumble recovery. And the Dolphins have it at the Cowboys 16.
Oh, boy.
They already lead 7-0. Trying to get more.
And Greasy is certainly smoothing it out at quarterback. He looks like he's in perfect shape again.
Amazing how sharp he is after missing all that time with a bad knee. With glasses. Bob Greasy calls him. Delvin with it. Mark Washington, one of the tacklers, the first hit. Helped by Aaron Kyle. It is tough to run against Dallas. Atlanta Falcons 21-10 over San Francisco. And by the way, in that game, O.J. Simpson suffered a separated shoulder. A tough time for the Juice.
There's the big blue on defense, and they're already down 7-0 after the opening drive by the Dolphins when Greasy really put it up well.
Those of you that watched Atlanta, San Francisco, welcome to the Orange Bowl in Miami, where the Dolphins lead the Cowboys 7-0 with 10:50 left to play first quarter. Greasy drops. Tillman at the one. And Charlie Waters made the tackle, and Greasy still hasn't missed.
Now, Tillman is 6'5", and caught 8 passes against New England, so you know he can play. Watch the pass protection. That's Newman on the left, Little and Langer down the middle, and the ball is right on, and he is a big moose at tight end.
The ball is right there. First and goal, Dolphins. They lead 7-0 already. Still with 10 minutes, 10 seconds left to play first quarter. Pulak. Not quite. Thomas Henderson hit him in the hole. Same play they scored on before.
This is the old 30 straight. You try to pick wherever you can go. You're right. Newman tried to get the cross block. This time the Cowboys really sealed it up. Henderson wrestles him down like an Apache from behind.
About a foot left is all. For the Dolphin touchdown, it would be number 2 of the day. Very quickly. After the fumble by Dorsett. Miami trying to capitalize. Dolphins are saying he made it. Gordon McCarter, the referee, has not acknowledged that as yet. Realize bang straight ahead. Thomas Henderson again, the tackler.
That defensive team's only given up 6 touchdowns rushing before today, so make it 7. You get down inside there, and I'm telling you, they're 250 apiece across the middle and all Class A players. Will you go back down the middle again?
They only need a foot. Wonder about Greasy's mobility after that knee injury. Good spot for the rollout option sometimes.
That's some offensive line, though.
One of the best. They get to Williams. Yeah.
There he is, out of Kansas University. 4 years. I'm telling you, about as classy a young man as you'll ever be around. Delvin Williams to the right side. Follows the block of the fullback. Man, he came exploding through there.
It is 13-0 Miami now as the Primian will have Don Strock to hold again. Primian has hit Flipper the second's tank twice.
Flipper's going to be tired.
At this rate he is. They went 15 yards in 5 plays. They lead 14-0. You got that list of...
That Den Herter came right over the top, didn't he? You could come right by Rayfield?
Yeah. I don't know. The wind's blowing. What else you want to know?
That's the way they started out with Minnesota, wasn't it? Look at Boo take him in. See, Boo takes the linebacker, goes up over. Sandy, who are you going to give me on this? Like the Star Brights, but we can't put them on right now. He hasn't been kicking these very deep. I guess we should mention that. He doesn't get at the end zone very much.
Well, look where they're standing.
Yeah, yeah.
Garrow, your Primian to kick off. The story of the last scoring drive, the line drive, comes down to Randy White. That's a looking rush.
Pretty good move on, didn't he? A little wrinkle by number 54.
Sean Clancy made the tackle on Randy White, but the Cowboys will have it at the 40-yard line.
Boy, that is something. That Cowboys turning the ball over, and, of course, the Vikings took advantage. It was 14-zip before... Men in Blue got it untracked, and I'll tell you, the Dolphins look like they really have a game plan, and they're sticking with it. They know what they can do.
Roger Staubach. The Cowboys have only run two plays. They trail 14-0 already. Billy Joe Dupree does not get away from the grasp of Kim Bokamper. He is a huge linebacker, 6'6".
Yeah, and he's young. He's only in his second year. And Bokamper took Dupree that time and stopped him, nailed him on the line of scrimmage. And he's bigger than Billy Joe. Bokamper, 6'6", 250, and he's a linebacker.
Steve Toll comes out now, and second and 8 yards the Cowboys need for a first.
Tony Hill and Drew Pearson to the bottom of the screen together.
Dorsett and Newhouse behind Roger Staubach. Dorsett gets the carry. He is wrapped up by Bob Baumhauer just as he gets back to the line of scrimmage.
The big nose man from Alabama, also in his second year. I told you Shula can do wonders with young people.
This telecast is presented by Authority of the National Football League. It's intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Miami Dolphins and the National Football League is prohibited.
And Preston Pearson is in the game. And it's a trips left formation. It's a shotgun.
Out of the shotgun, that's right. John Fitzgerald's one-handed snap was low. Blitz is on. Roger Staubach gets away from one of them. Going deep for Billy Joe Dupree. Got him. He stopped. He quit running. Norris Thomas back there with him.
Well, Thomas thinks he was interfered with, and Dupree might have hit him because I don't think Dupree's ever been that deep for a pass in his life.
Dallas will have to punt. Tim Foley, Norris Thomas arguing with the officiating staff right now. Watch it again.
The ball is thrown a ton. Now watch if Billy Joe uses his left arm a little bit, because Thomas is trying to see if Thomas might have backed in. But that's football. Let him play. The ball was thrown a ton.
Dupree might have misjudged it a little bit. The ball sailed over his head. Danny White now back in front formation. Jimmy Cephalo, deep for Miami. Danny White really nails this one. Cephalo fields at the 7-yard line. Comes back to the 15. Flag is down. Two flags are down. Got to be clipping.
Thomas Henderson got clipped by number 48. I believe that was Gerald Small that clipped Henderson. But the Dolphins have the 14-0 scoreboard lead.
Clip is correct. Gordon McCarter will let us know if we're right about Small being the culprit.
Looked to me like the Dallas secondary is playing pretty deep on those first patterns to Duriel Harris, huh?
They're way off the ball. You're right.
Personal foul, clipping.
Benny Barnes.
Receivers during the return.
Right.
First down.
It is 14-0. The Dolphins over the Cowboys with 6:52 left to play in the first quarter.
How paranoid the defensive backs are getting now, too.
Yeah. You know, yeah, we do this.
You know, he really wanted to get a flag on that.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't have any contact with the secondary anymore, forget it.
I don't know what he was upset about. There was really not much there.
I was barely touched.
Yeah.
Boy, Roger threw that one. That wind must be a little bit more than you think this way. It looks like a crosswind. Mm-hmm. That ball really took off. Man, that's some start by Miami, huh?
Okay. Have him hang on to that. Preceding announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Football League.
Those are the Miami Star Brights, but Greasy's darn near perfect. He's 4 for 4 for 84 yards.
Cleveland 10, Houston 7, third quarter. Don Cockroft just kicked the field goal for the Browns to make the score 10-7. 40-yarder. On first down.
Leroy Harris.
Charlie Waters made the tackle.
Pat, you realize that Shula has two offensive backs. Leroy Harris, 4 point something a shot. And Delvin Williams at 5.1 a shot. He can almost get 10 yards with two carries with two running backs like that.
That's the final score there. Seattle beat the Chicago Bears. That's their seventh straight loss. Seattle 31-29 over the Bears. Straight ahead again is Leroy Harris, number 38. For a couple, Thomas Henderson, one of the tacklers, along with Cliff Harris.
Now the third down where the Cowboys are supposed to rule. Their nickel defense has allowed only like 40% of the conversion to be made. We'll see what Shula has in mind. Bringing in another flanker. I see Cefalo coming in.
Dallas puts in Dennis Thurman, Randy Hughes, and Larry Cole. Out goes Jethro Pugh. Frank Corral, a field goal to give Los Angeles a 3-0 lead over Tampa Bay. It's third and five for Bob Greasy. Bulosh and Williams behind him. Handoff is to Williams.
Oh.
Near a first down, and what a good call.
Oh, I mean, Larry Little, the big right guard, number 66, came across, and they run a quick trap. Watch the right part of your screen, 66, go across. Take Randy White, knock him completely down. And Delvin Williams hits the crack right as it opens. I don't think he made it.
He got close, but perhaps not quite.
He is strong when he is hit. When he's tackled, he really makes a move. Oh, yeah.
He did get it. Key first down for the Dolphins. They lead 14-0.
Pat, that tandem of Little, Langer, and Kuchenberg or Newman, if those people are in there, they are the strongest darn drive blockers for the run you'll almost see anywhere.
They are in there. Kuchenberg, of course, used to be a guard. Has now moved out to tackle. Little next to Langer. Mike Curran is the offensive tackle, number 71. And Greasy throws outside to Rio Harris. A good, sure tackle, this time by Mark Washington.
How about the gambling of number 12? That was, he started to throw it early, and then he almost said, Duriel, come on back. Let me hit you a little bit further back here. Very casually thrown.
Greasy is perfect. No gain on that completion, however. It'll make it second and 10. The line of scrimmage, Miami 16. Leroy Harris and Delvin Williams, the setbacks behind Bob Greasy. Harris. Cuts back inside, is also near another first down. Perhaps he got it. D.D. Lewis and Charlie Waters, the tacklers.
Leroy Harris is 5'9 and a half, 220. And I'm telling you, if you don't tackle him at the ankles, Thurman tries there. Well, that was Kyle that went by first. This young man can wade right through your secondary.
Another Dolphin first down. And now at the Dallas, at the Dolphin 28. Dallas defense being pressured.
They pulled off the ball a little bit, too. I noticed Dallas isn't crowding that line of scrimmage quite as much.
They're in the flex now. They took Carl Jones off the ball, and Jethro Pugh up close to the offensive line. And again, Greasy sidearms, and this time out of bounds. The first time he's missed. Intended for Duriel Harris.
And no pressure. Everybody was coming and working, but that bunch for the Dolphins straightened them up pretty close to the line of scrimmage.
See what happened to Randy White.
All right, Randy White, number 54, making his move. He was on the unflexed side. You can see Newman hanging in there. Randy is giving it the gung-ho approach.
He got near Greasy with that last bound. 3:29 left to play. Denver leads the Jets 14-0 in the first quarter. Game in Denver. Andre Tillman moves over to the right side, and the two backs shift their position. Greasy backpedals and throws. Wide open is Delvin Williams. Wide open. Cliff Harris finally made the tackle, but Gracie had Delvin Williams wide open.
Well, that time Tom Henderson went to the right flat, and Bruni came over and helped on the left side. Now watch what the left part of your screen. You can see Bruni going to the right, leaving, and Henderson went to the sidelines. And there's nobody home now but safety men.
Gracie is now 7 out of 8 for 112 yards. All at the Miami 46 now. The Dolphins have been able to move at will.
I wonder what Henderson was chasing out there. There's nobody even out there.
And Brunig went the other way. Another Dolphin first down. The Cowboys have none. Flag is down in the middle of the line. Jethro Pugh made the tackle on Leroy Harris.
Might have caught the big tight end, Tillman, number 87. He is an excellent blocker, but there's a darn much going on now in the techniques of pass blocking and then rush blocking. I don't know how they know what they're doing.
They'll walk it off against the Dolphins. A sellout crowd at the Orange Bowl in Miami for this match between Dallas and the
Holding,
Dolphins.
Number 62, offense, repeat first down.
Mr. Langer, huh?
Right.
This is 100th straight game. You know, more importantly, though, Langer has never missed a practice. And all of us have tried to miss a practice, either go see our shrink or something, right?
One of the strongest guys anywhere. His arms look like that tank that Flipper the Second it is. Bob Gracie on first down, sets his offensive unit. Ball back at the Miami 36, and Gracie's going to go down the middle. Now, Andre Tillman is wide open. Charlie Waters came over to knock him down, but more than enough for another Dolphin first down.
The tight end got about 35 yards off the line of scrimmage. Watch the pass blocking now. Langer will come out and look for some place to help. He doesn't even have anybody to mop up on. They cut everybody. The Dallas defense last year was number one, and at this stage, they're 18th.
That's against the pass.
Against the pass.
Here's Randy White again.
Newman got enough of him, didn't he?
Just enough to get him down. First down at the Dallas 31. The Dolphins already lead it 14-0. This time, Randy White puts on some heat, but Thomas Henderson makes the sack.
31st sack for the Cowboys. The Eagles beat the Dolphins rather easily early in the year, 17-3, by controlling the football on offense, just not letting Miami go to work. Of course, Gracie was not at quarterback either.
A minute 39, a minute 38 now make it left in the first quarter. Dallas has only run 5 plays.
Gracie has 33 200-yard days in this league in 12 years.
That's an amazing statistic.
Incredible.
Boy, you can just watch him from behind as we did with Andre Tillman a minute ago and see him looking around and just reading that defense like he knows it oh so well. It looks like he does so far, doesn't
it? It does.
Gracie drops. Wide open is Andre Tillman. Charlie Waters made the tackle, but Tillman is wide open all the time, it seems.
Well, the theory might be you're going to have to double on Nat Moore and Duriel Harris. At that time, it was actually Waters that was trying to dog this big guy and just couldn't handle him.
Tillman finally has recovered from a knee operation enough so that he has regained much of his speed that he had. Gracie now 9 out of 10 for 159 yards. He's always been a good blocker, as Tom Brookshire said a minute ago. Here comes Andre Tillman out of the game.
And Gracie calls his own plays. Doesn't do a bad job calling his own, does he?
They go with 3 wide receivers now as Cephalo is in the game. No tight end. Thrown in the direction of Boulash, covered by Charlie Waters. But he just threw it away. The pressure was on a little bit.
I think Gracie saw the safety blitz. Harris came, Thomas Henderson came, and better part of valor that time.
Looks strange, doesn't it? With those glasses on under the helmet.
Played golf with him one day in the Bogey Buster out in Dayton, Ohio, and he never hit a tee shot straight, and he never lost his temper, not once. Just kept hitting it into the woods.
Don Struck will hold for that man, Garo Euphrimian. 5 out of 9 on the year. The Cowboys didn't have enough people in the game. And now Brunig comes back. This will be from 45 yards out. It'll get there. It's good. 17-0. With 14 seconds left to play in the first quarter.
The sixth field goal for your Brendan, the number six.
The Dolphins have dominated throughout this first quarter.
Where was that one from?
45.
45? Just had enough to get it there, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you.
They look good.
Do they look good? I mean to tell you, he can really tear you up. Greasy can really tear you up.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen anybody.
I've never seen anybody looking any better.
Look at the whole thing. He looks like he sees the whole damn pattern, doesn't he? Huh? Now they're humping up and blitzing people about three out of four plays now.
Well, that's when he's really going to kill them.
Yeah.
I don't know how he could do any better.
He used to be a 60-40 offensive guy, you know, 60 run. Not now, not this game. What is the ratio of run against pass with Greasy then? How many passes are you throwing against runs? He's 50-50, huh? Okay. 50-50. Pass? 11 passes?
Gary Primian just kicked a 45-yard field goal to put the Miami Dolphins ahead of Dallas 17-0. And the first quarter's not over yet. In the direction of Butch Johnson. There's no place to go but out of bounds. Knocked out by Norris Thomas, the cornerback.
The Dolphins have run 21 offensive plays, and 11 have been passes. I remember when Miami used to be a 60-run, 40-pass type offense, but not today against the Dallas team.
Coming up tonight on CBS, first 60 minutes, followed by All in the Family, Alice, Kaz, and then Dallas. Solid lineup this evening on this network. Solid football game right here with Dallas confused at the moment and trailing Miami 17-0. 5 seconds left to go, first quarter, as Staubach is going to throw. Thought about it. Tim Bocamper. And a flag goes down. Shula looking on from in front of the Dolphin bench.
They might have thought Bocamper used the headgear as he inhaled number 12. At 6'6", he just sort of enveloped the man that used to play for Navy.
That should be the last play of the first quarter. And they'll walk it off. And then they'll tell us. Sometimes we have problems with this wireless microphone.
Mask. Defense. 5-yard penalty.
In this stadium, for some reason, there was a face mask violation called against Kim Bocamper.
He tried to take the whole helmet.
That was, as we said, the last play of the first quarter. That's the end of the first quarter with the score 17-0, Miami.
Game. I'm just wondering... Dallas doesn't catch up real well anymore, baby. Opponents passes. Okay, opponents passes. The Giants threw 37 passes in their first game in Dallas. Los Angeles threw 25. St. Louis threw 30. Minnesota threw 32. I don't know if anybody's ever come up just... going to be interesting.
Late in the fourth quarter, Philadelphia 10, Green Bay 3. In the fourth quarter, Oakland 14, Kansas City 3. Final.
He has cause to look concerned.
Better believe it. This is the big scoring period for the Cowboys. They have like 80 points of their 184 totally get in the second period. This would be a good time to get about half of them.
They need some right now. 17-0, the Dolphins lead. Robert Newhouse and Tony Dorsett, the running backs, and this is Dorsett.
This time they brought the tight end, Billy Joe Dupree, down, and he blocked from the outside. Dorsett picked the block up in pretty good shape. He is still quick. You see the trap block there to your left as Dupree, the tight end, sort of sprung him.
Rusty Chambers and Vern Den Herter made the tackle. Dorsett got about six. Don Shula has to be happy about the way things have gone so far. Los Angeles 10, Tampa Bay nothing. Nolan Cromwell off a fake field goal scored the touchdown. That's Robert Newhouse. About a yard short of a first. In the first quarter, by the way, Miami had 164 yards in total offense. Dallas minus two. Bob Baumhauer made that last tackle.
Time of possession. Miami had the ball 12 minutes and 32 seconds. The Cowboys, the Super Bowl champions, 2:28.
Jackie Smith checks into the game. Double tight end situation for Dallas. Jackie Smith on the right, Billy Joe Dupree on the left. Butch Johnson is in there as well. Quarterback draw play as Staubach gets into Miami territory. They knock him back out of there. Rick Volk was the man who made the first contact. He was helped out by
Here's a Rusty quarterback Chambers. That has over 2,000 yards rushing. Makes the fake outside. You can see Den Herter taking the fake. Towel and Chambers, the linebackers, have made that false step.
Just inside Dolphin territory is where they put it down.
Notice he didn't go down and slide under anybody. It looks like he's going to try to fight it himself, huh?
Like this, with the score 17-0, there won't be much sliding. First down, Dallas. Roger Staubach fake and drops. Is hit, but finds Newhouse, who drops it. Staubach really got hit by Bob Baumhauer.
And A.J. Dewey.
A.J. Dewey.
Came from the blind side. Roger faked that play action, and nobody made a move on the line of scrimmage. They just came for him.
Oakland 14, Kansas City 10. It'll be second and 10 for Dallas. Miami has controlled the football game so far. Dallas is one first down. 12:55 left to play in the first half. Staubach has the good protection, throws outside Dorsett. Gets away from one, but not the pursuit by Bob Baumhauer.
What a job by the nose guard. Baumhauer goes all the way outside. He gets good linebacking play because he stopped the play and made number 33 just freeze up. Roger wants to go somewhere else. He doesn't want to go out in the flat, even to Dorsett. Okay, Rusty Chambers makes him turn inside, and the nose guard comes out and makes the tackle.
Tim Foley helped out. Preston Pearson and Tony Dorsett, the running backs. Roger Staubach back in the shotgun formation now. They're blitzing. Drew Pearson. It'll be a Dallas first down. Game number 55, I believe, that Drew Pearson has caught a pass.
What a block by Tony Dorsett, number 33.
It would be 55 in a row that Drew has caught a pass.
Watch the left part of your screen, Patrick, and number 33 is trying to do it. Let's see if we can pick it up on this one. There he is on the left. He sticks the, that's Gordon, the big linebacker coming through, and I'll tell you, Dorsett gave Roger time to throw it and hit Pearson.
Second quarter score, that is 3-0, San Diego over Cincinnati. First down for the Dallas Cowboys line of scrimmage, the Miami 37. Newhouse and Preston Pearson running back now as Dorsett gets a rest. And Staubach is going to get a rest. Vern Den Herter with help from Bob Baumhauer and A.J. Dewey, the front three.
Den Herter came right over the top of Rayfield Wright, and Tony Hill was running a deep post pattern and looked like he might be clearing open. Big Cat just couldn't handle Den Herter that time.
Rayfield Wright is number 70. Loss of about 10. Ball goes back to the 47-yard line where it'll be second and 20.
I need to tell you that Dolphin defense, they're popped and fired up too, aren't they?
Staubach is 3 out of 5 for just 13 yards so far. He'll have to throw again. Dorsett back in the game. And this time it's a sweep to Dorsett with Burton Lawless out in front. Down to the 40, and again down goes the flag.
We're going to get Rich Folk for grabbing the face mask.
Rick Volk, who was with Baltimore, then with the Giants, then came back with the Miami Dolphins. And you saw the preliminary indication, which will be a face mask violation against Miami. A sellout crowd and a beautiful day in the Orange Bowl.
But that was a pretty desperate play for the Cowboys to throw a running play on 20 yards to go. They weren't near a first down with it.
Here's the penalty.
Face mask, number 21 defense, automatic first down.
It is, as you heard Gordon McCarter say, an automatic first down. Watch number 21.
Yeah, he got it all right. With Dorsett sometime, that's all you can get.
So it'll be first down Dallas at the Miami 35. Drew Pearson in motion. Dorsett the carrier.
Oh.
Maybe one before Bob Baumhauer wrapped him up.
Oh, that Baumhauer really, really played Fitzgerald that time. Was actually, Dorsett danced straight up ahead and tried to get the nose man to commit himself, and Baumhauer still made the tackle.
At Miami defense, Rob Carpenter scored on a one-yard run to put Houston a little bit closer to Cleveland, or in fact ahead of Cleveland, 14-10, 7:28 left fourth quarter.
Rogers got to throw it, hasn't he?
I would think so. He has Newhouse and Dorsett behind him, or did for a while. Dorsett just left. Billy Joe Dupree hustled out of bounds by Kim Bocamper.
Dupree must think Bocamper's going to go back on the charter flight to Dallas with him. Every time 89 moves, 58's all over him.
Bob Matheson goes into the Miami defense now, and Steve Toll comes out. Natural grass.
Well, that is a nice surface.
It really is.
Good drainage under there, all those pipes and pumps and everything.
Description: athletic turf. They can drain it or they can water it from underneath. Denver 14-7 over the Jets. Third down situation for Dallas. They need 7 for a first. Roger goes to the shotgun. Billy Joe Dupree, and he'll have it. They hustle him back, Tim Foley and some company from Miami, but he had enough. Charlie Babb was helping out. But Roger Staubach, with that completion to Billy Joe Dupree, gets a Dallas first down.
Boy, great catch by Dupree, too, because he had to fight off a couple of people as he was trying to get up off the ground to catch it. Ball thrown a little bit high, so take what you can get when you're back 17-zip. Looked like they might have stunned it on defense. It was picked up pretty well. That's good effort by Dupree, I'll tell you.
Ball was zipped well by Staubach. It'll be first down Dallas at the 23. Straight ahead is Newhouse. 4 or 5 before he's wrestled down by number 73, Bob Baumhauer. See how he worked.
Nose man, 6'5". They said he was too tall to play nose. He straightens Fitzgerald up. That time Fitzgerald did his job. A little too much time for the stubby one to come roaring through.
6-yard pickup, and they'll take that every time. Making second down 4 is Newhouse and Preston Pearson. Were the backs for a moment, and now they are again. As they shift around, as Dallas does. Billy Joe Dupree goes in motion. Pitch back to Newhouse. He lunges down to about the 15 inside that, but Larry Gordon, number 50, wrapped him up with some help again from Baumhauer.
Gordon makes some kind of a play. He just stood in the hole and took the blocker on, straightened it up, and gets a clean shot at Newhouse and does not lose the battle. Watch this. Takes on Dupree. Lets Pearson slip on by. Watch it, 50, get rid of it. Arizona State All-American. Remember when we did the Fiesta Bowl and he was there?
Good player. Third, they need two. Ball at the Miami 15. Dolphins lead 17-0. Big throw, and this is Preston Pearson inside the five to the two. Dallas first down, Ken Foley the tackler. I think he caught him off balance.
Pearson's got about a five-yard average, and what he wants to do is be called a starter as a football player. He likes to run with it.
And he can.
Oh, of course he can. He's under control. You won't see him fumble much. He's a very steady person on Sunday afternoons.
It'll be first and goal, Dallas, at the Miami 2. The Dolphins lead it 17-0 already. But Dallas threatening. First drive they put together. Newhouse moves behind Staubach. It should be the house. Curtis Johnson, number 45, and again Baumhauer with a piece of that tackle.
Some kind of a play. Matheson gets into it too. Watch the upper part of your screen, and the cornerback comes over, slips a block by Pearson, and then tries to get some help from Friends.
Lost about a foot or two, so it'll be second and goal, Dallas. Ball still at the two-yard line, just outside that, the hand of John Fitzgerald, with Roger Staubach behind him. Again, it's the house. Curtis Johnson says nothing doing. No place to go. Charlie Babb came over to help out.
That time, Newhouse put his head down. What he should have done was look a little bit and try to get an angle. He ran right into Curtis Johnson. Watch the top part of your screen. Newhouse gets his head down. He doesn't realize that he almost made that tackle for Johnson.
Johnson got just a little bit lower than he did. Newhouse goes out. Preston Pearson. There's the lone running back. Double tight end. Jackie Smith on one side and Dupree on the other. Roger Staubach is going to throw. A.J. Dewey and Bob Baumhauer and Vern Den Herder knock him backwards, and they'll have to settle for a field goal.
A.J. Dewey got Roger almost before he got set up. I don't think he gets his arm back. Watch what happens now. The top of the screen, you'll see 77. He did a game. He played a game. He came up the middle and got Roger before he even got it up.
He got inside Pat Donovan, and Staubach had no chance. Raphael Septian with Charlie Waters holding at the 20-yard line. It'll be a 30-yard field goal attempt. They're on the board. 5:06 left to play before the half. Septian hits that field goal, making it 17-3. The Dolphins over the Cowboys.
Some defensive stand.
Those three guys up front or something, aren't they?
Yeah, but looks to me like Dallas is playing in a quandary. Dallas looks like they're going through motions or something sometimes, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, it looks that way when you're getting whipped a lot of times too. Looks like they're waiting for somebody else to do the job or something all the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, great. Septian will kick off. Duriel Harris and Gary Davis and Jimmy Cephalo back. With Harris in the middle for the Dolphins.
See how the Cowboys cover this and see if they're ready to snap out of it. Looks to me like some of them are going through the motions.
Line shot in the direction of Davis. And he lets it go out of bounds, and they'll have to back up to the 30. The flag is down just to mark the spot where it went out of bounds.
Bet you think she's just another pretty face, don't you?
That's what I thought. Isn't she?
She got her tied funny, though.
By the way, we told you that St. Louis had picked up its second victory over the Giants. Jim Otis ran for two touchdowns, and Jim Hart threw a touchdown pass to Al Chandler. That final score again was St. Louis 20, New York 10.
Tell you what, the Cardinals have earned it, though, baby. They never stopped hitting, even when they were 0-0.
That must have been quite an emotional speech that Jim Bakken made after they won the first game last week in the locker room. Quite a tribute to Bud Wilkinson.
Yeah, he's a pretty good stretch runner, isn't he? He didn't panic. Septian's kicking into a pretty good breeze right now. I'd say it's whipping around 15 or 20 knots.
Coming out of that open end of the Orange Bowl just almost directly against Raphael Septian. Dallas ran off 19 plays and came up with 3 points. Good kick. All the way back to the one is Duriel Harris. He broke a couple of tackles up to about the 30-yard line and passed that.
Didn't Kyle make that tackle?
Yeah. Tomorrow night on CBS, WKRP in Cincinnati.
Good station.
People, MASH, one day at a time, and Lou Grant. By the way, on People, our old friend Phyllis George will be throwing the spotlight on Liza Minnelli, Bonnie Franklin.
And your tennis friend, huh?
Guillermo Vilas. Is
he your doubles partner or something?
No. I wouldn't be doing this if he was. 4:47 left to play before the half as Bob Greasy gets to Delvin Williams. And the Cowboy defense led by Harvey Martin converged. Maybe lost one.
Dede Lewis really gets wrapped to the bottom of your right of your screen. That was Leroy Harris, the fullback, took him. But Harvey Martin comes through and makes a very affirmative move. That might have been the best lick that the Dallas defense has made off the ball. Looked like they snapped off that time.
He got off the inside block of Andre Tillman. Oakland 20, Kansas City 10. That's the final score. Greasy gets the Bulldogs. And boom. Gets outside the 30. Don Shula.
Now, Greasy will go back in that huddle and say, all right, give me some receivers. Let's see if I can read the whole field. And, Pat, it looks to me like Greasy does read the whole field when he's looking at a pass pattern develop.
That's Cliff Harris being looked at now by the Dallas medical staff. Don Shula.
I'm going to have to leave, too.
The leader among the active coaches in victories, and right behind him is the Dallas coach, Tom Landry. That's the score.
Bye, we've got a lot of scores. We've gotten through most of your scores there for a while. We've done a lot of scores. Seems like we've done that Houston.
It'll be third down, Miami, as Don Shula looks on. His team leads 17-3 with 3:42 left before the half at the sold-out Orange Bowl in Miami. Bob Greasy has been spectacular in the first half. Here's Harris is out. Randy Hughes is in. Here's Delvin Williams. Randy Hughes came up from that safety position, helped out by Bob Brunig, and shut off the Dolphins short of a first down.
They get this one, it's a nail. 24-3 at half's tough, baby. Because you go into their locker room and there are 38 coaches trying to tell you what's wrong. You spend 18 minutes fighting among your own players to say, what are we going to change? That kid timed that perfectly on Butch Johnson.
Didn't he, though? You could see it coming.
What was his name? What was the fellow's name?
44. What's his name? Cornelius?
Cornelius?
Yeah.
Huh?
He hit, he hit Butch.
Maybe he couldn't time any better than that. About half a second after Butch touched that ball and got it started down, it was hit.
Two minutes to play in the first half. The Dolphins 17, the Cowboys 3.
Greasy took off his glasses and sort of, you know, fogged him up the way you do. He blew on him a little bit. He's a very calm man. And Shula claims that his locker even is perfectly selected and it's orderly and his clothes are all laid out. Not like mine was.
The Dolphins haven't been able to run too well, but they sure have been able to pass. The blitz is on. Uriel Harris, the intended receiver. The defender is Aaron Kyle, and he was very close to pass interference.
Oh, but gosh, if you can't make a brush a person's body as you're going for the ball yourself, you better put King's X on people. Good quick post.
Cliff Harris, I believe, has returned to the game for Dallas. Denver 21-7 over the New York Jets. In the second quarter, Craig Penrose, by the way, is the Denver quarterback in place of Craig Morton. Third 11 here. 17-3 to score. Miami just recovered a fumble to get this close. Gary Davis. Cowboys outside. Greasy's going through with it. Cliff Harris back on the coverage. Pass intended for Nat Moore. That's who he likes in this area.
Inside the 20-yard line, Nat Moore is like a flycatcher. He has 7 TDs already. I think Too Tall Jones lifted his 6'9" frame up early. This little guy in close, I'm telling you. And Harris got away with scraping him.
Barely got a hand on it, I think.
Looks like Cliff Harris is wearing one of those rings. He might have gotten his neck popped, huh? Collar?
Like he got caught in that sandwich. He made that tackle. That's why he had to leave. Here's Too Tall. Let's see if he does jump.
Offside.
Not much doubt about it, is there?
72 defense. Repeat third down.
Know where he can go at 6'9".
We get to stay around at the half with all the scores and highlights with Brent and Jane and Irv. Steve Bartkowski, by the way, had a big day today for Atlanta as the Falcons improved their record. Ran for one touchdown. Threw for a touchdown. Like he's coming into his own. Third down here. DC has a blitz coming after him and has to throw it away. The pass was in the area of Andre Tillman.
Well, I'll tell you, Cliff Harris just wouldn't let Tillman make the outside move. Greasy had to go ahead and unload it. Looked to me like that Kyle had Matt Moore pretty well covered in the corner of the end zone, too.
Don Strzok, who is the backup quarterback, or one of them for the Dolphins, is the holder. So, of course, he can throw it. He carried the load while Greasy was hurt, and very well.
He threw the touchdown pass out of this formation against Baltimore last week to Den Herter.
Arrow from him. From 28 yards away. Trying to make it 20-3. And should. And does. Don Strzok is the first man to say it's good, the holder. It's always a pretty good indicator. A minute, 41 seconds left to play before halftime. Dolphins 20-3 over Dallas.
I'll tell you, that helped the cause. They didn't get a touchdown down there then. That's the guy's got his thumb in the dike anyway.
That would be nice. Huh?
Last time they had one of those, I can't remember when the Cowboys had a kickoff return. If they ever had. Well, I guess Gekner was the last guy that did it. 66.
Bob Hayes.
Yeah. Stay with your premium, see what he does.
You jump up and down. You'll be second.
'71 looks like the last one, I guess.
Gary Aprimian will kick off. Alois Blackwell and Butch Johnson will be deep for Dallas. Blackwell at about the 10, Johnson back inside the 5. It's going to be Johnson. The 11. To about the 33 before he's knocked down by Norris Thomas. Gary Aprimian taking a little stroll on Tuesday night on CBS. The election coverage. And covered like nobody else can do it with those guys.
That's some lineup. It's a World Series team, eh?
I'll say. It's an all-pro line.
Cronkite's batting cleanup, I bet you.
Should be. Harry Reasoner, Roger Mudd, Dan Rather, Leslie Stahl, and the rest.
Little cowboy affirmative thing might be settling for the field goal that Miami had, too, instead of getting 7 after that turnover. They've got their thumb in the dike anyway.
Dallas has all 3 of their timeouts remaining as Roger Staubach drops immediately into the shotgun. Throws a little jump shot over the middle to Preston Pearson. He's got a first down. He's in Dolphin territory. Larry Gordon finally downed him. But the Cowboys hustle up to the line of scrimmage and the Dolphins stroll back.
Halfback screen middle, and they caught the 3-man front that time. Really just stunning their way out right out of the defense.
Shotgun again. John Fitzgerald with that one-handed snap without looking. Back to Staubach, and the protection is good. Preston Pearson again gets out of bounds and stops it. Bob Matheson knocked him out of bounds. 1:03 left to play before halftime. 20-3. Don't forget to stick around at the half. Well, we'll have scores and highlights from around the league, and there have been a lot of them today.
You know, the crazy place to go at halftime would be go to the Dallas locker room, because you're going to have about 58 theories on how they can turn it around in the second half. They'll argue for 18 minutes and then barely get back out and get underway.
Broncos rolling today, 28-7 now over the New York Jets. Told you before that Craig Pimrose is the Denver quarterback today. First down, second down, Dallas from the shotgun again. Staubach's protection is good. It's picked off by Rick Bolt, I believe. No, Charlie Babb. No, it's Tim Foley. I was wrong twice. Number 25.
This is the old Super Bowl Dolphin. Foley's the last guy there. He and Curtis Johnson that played defense on those Super Bowl teams. Look at this move. Clean and legal.
He wanted the ball, I'd say. The Dolphins will take it over. They have been outstanding.
I don't know what happened to my Miami stats here.
I got some somewhere, Tony.
Well, I just had them, and they must have blown over in the sack or something.
Here you go.
Are these Miami's?
Yeah.
Yeah, here we are. That's okay. I got some. Thank you. Let me just. It's Foley's 4th. Team 17th. Made a good move on it, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Huh? He sure did.
How many turnovers is that for Dallas? 2 fumbles, interception, 3.
3,
huh?
3. The Dolphins have not used any of their timeouts, so they're in good shape. Not only on the scoreboard, but as far as timeout situation is concerned.
It's a 17th interception for the team and the 4th for Foley. 3 turnovers for Dallas already.
Line of scrimmage, the Miami 28. Braxton and Williams, and this is Delvin Williams. No place to go. Harvey Martin, and I believe Mike Hegman might have been one of the tacklers for Dallas. Yeah.
Little, the pulling guard, tried to go by, and Harvey Martin tackled him first and stripped him and then got the ball carrier.
Hegman, I think, is playing in place of D.D. Lewis at the moment.
Dennis Thurman playing the right corner. And you trust Bob Greasy not. If the play is there, he will go ahead and put it up.
We got an extra defensive backfield set up. Dallas does as they just let the clock run. And Hegman again made the tackle. They're going to run out the clock and settle for this lead, as you would certainly expect by the half. And at 5 seconds, the Dolphins already headed for the locker room. Never seen them look better.
I've never seen the Cowboys more confused.
So that's the end of the first half. A sold-out Orange Bowl with the score, Miami 20, Dallas 3.
Are we going on camera?
I have to do that.
Okay, oh, for this, that's right. Okay.
I don't have the numbers on these guys. On these kids. Oh, yeah, here, dear. Let me have my coat.
Got your stuff? Coat? Get him the coat?
Yeah.
Get him his coat. That's his coat there.
I got him now. I got him now.
That's his coat, the blue coat.
Okay.
Well, I got to get out of here.
In a moment, we're going to see some of the youngsters who might be the pro players of tomorrow. But you know, it's 18 years from fast and kick, it drove a lot of memories. Huh? What? I'll just do it on this. Is this all right, Sandy? I'll just do it on the headset, huh? Okay. Headset, he said. Moment, we're going to see some of the youngsters who might be the pro players tomorrow. And it's 18 years, front pass and kick. It's filled a lot of memories for a lot of kids. For example, you know, yeah. Well, I've got this standard copy. What? Okay. In a moment, we're going to see some youngsters who might be the pro players of tomorrow. In this 18 years, punt, pass, and kick has built a lot of memories for a lot of kids. For example, take a look at this. Okay. In a moment, we're going to see some youngsters who might be the pro players of tomorrow. In its 18 years, punt, pass, and kick has built a lot of memories for a lot of kids. For example, take a look at this. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. Thank you, Gene. In a moment, we're going to see some youngsters who just might be the pro players of tomorrow. In its 18 years, punt, pass, and kick has built a lot of memories for a lot of kids. For example, take a look at this one. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Am I on PA? Earlier today, these contestants participated in the kicking and punting portions of the competition. So now, if the judges are ready, we will begin our passing competition with the first 8-year-old contestant. Number 12, from Cobbtown, Georgia, Sonny Humans. Our next 8-year-old passer from Pahokee, Florida, number 10, Moore Young. Good toss. And now the 9-year-old, number 24, from Brooklet, Georgia, Billy Tillman. From Miami, the next 9-year-old, number 25, Bill Henderson. Next, our 10-year-old contestants, first from Jessup, Georgia, number 32, Lee Nichols. Right on it. The other 10-year-old thrower, from Hollywood, Florida, number 22, Patrick Fresca. And now to the 11-year-olds, number 20, from Jacksonville, Florida, Chris Gay. The other 11-year-old, number 30, from Pembroke Pines, Florida, Wayne Stopsky. Moving now to the 12-year-old contestants. Number 23 from Stark, Florida, Richie Fender. The other 12-year-old contestant, number 42 from Naples, Florida, David Spearman. And finally, our 13-year-olds from Bunnell, Florida, number 34, Terrence Stewart. And finally, number 44 from Pahokee, Florida, Walter Johnson. Gosh. That completes the passing competition. The officials will tabulate the scores, and the winners will be announced at the end of the third quarter. We'll return to the Orange Bowl in Miami after this word from your local station. Thank you. Yes, Andy. You got a commercial card for me? He says we're going to have... Oh, it's just a countdown? Okay, okay. That's the story at the half. Miami 20, Dallas 3. The Dolphins broke out to a 17-0 lead at the end of the first quarter. Touchdowns by Boulash and Delvin Williams and a field goal by Premian. He added one more just before the half. Preseason announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Football League. Garrow, your premium. Set to kick off. Alois Blackwell and Butch Johnson back deep for Dallas. Blackwell is 24. And here is your premium as he starts the second half. Butch Johnson at the two. Broke one tackle and stumbled to about the 24. A little scuffle goes on. Here are a few statistics to study as to what happened in the first half. Look at that.
Passing yardage. Staubach was 7 of 10 for 48 yards, but they lost some yardage. Greasy was 9 of 13 for 159 and a long one of 42, the one to Delvin Williams.
It'll be first down Dallas. The Dolphins lead the Cowboys 20-3. Begins to get a little dark in the Orange Bowl. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire. The Dolphins dominated the first half and lead 23. That's Dorsett for about four over the left side. A.J. Dewey was the first man to make contact.
Every time you make a mistake against Miami, they take advantage of it. Interception, fumbles. Quite a staff he has. He has John Sandusky and Schellenbacher, head coaches that come along working for Don Shula.
Lawrence Barger, Tom Keen, Carl Tassett.
And they've prepared this team very well for today.
They certainly have. Line of scrimmage, the Dallas 29, as Staubach gets to Newhouse. He bounds around the middle, but Bob Bonhauer stacks him up. Not nearly enough for a first down. What else did you have on that page, the statistics, first half?
43 yards rushing for Dallas. That's gross. Only 18 for Miami, so Greasy has thrown the pass run percentage upside down.
Denver 28 now, the Jets 17. Pat Leahy just kicked a field goal, a 38-yarder. 48 seconds left to play in the second quarter. Preston Pearson and Robert Newhouse line up behind Roger Staubach. Left guard Herbert Scott beat the can a little bit.
Somebody started moving. I'll tell you, Miami is really up on their toes as soon as they even saw somebody flinch. There it was. Scott moved a foot. Now watch the Dolphins start coming. That's all they want, an excuse to hit you a lick side the head.
Fitzgerald got a lick side the head, didn't he? Gordon McCarter.
Procedure, false start, number 68.
David Scott. Matt Moore, who had a few aches and pains coming into the game, just got a little bit more tape. Shotgun formation for Dallas. Third down. They need seven. Inside handoff to Dorsett with some room in front. He got the first down.
Got a great block from Preston Pearson, too, number 26. He peeled back on the linebacker and did an awfully good job. A good call here out of the shotgun. Here they're trying to beat the computer. If you throw out of the shotgun most of the time, let's give it to number 33. Scott's out in front. Dorsett almost lost that ball.
Heck of a block by Scott, wasn't it? Charlie Babb made the tackle, by the way, number 49, was the extra defensive back. First down, Dallas at their own 36. They trail 20-3 as Staubach gets to Newhouse. There will be nothing there. As Bob Baumhauer again was the first man to get there. What a player.
Dallas tried to use a finesse play. They pulled Donovan to tackle like they were going wide and tried to run in behind it. Watch what happens. Watch the left part of your screen. Are they going really wide? Donovan's gone. They try to block down. And those linebackers move in behind that 35. Now Baumhauer is really playing the nose.
Steve Toll helped him out, number 56. Los Angeles 17. Tampa Bay 6. That's in the second quarter. Second down here, and they need 10 still. 12-18 left to play, third quarter. Miami up by 17. Protection is great for Tony Hill. Got it. What a catch by Tony Hill. A diving grab, spectacular by the second-year man from Stanford. What a catch, and what a throw.
Especially when you come in with a bad knee that's a little bit gimpy. He twisted it on Wednesday back in practice. Dorsett actually has Billy Joe Dupree, the tight end, open, but he decides to go for it. This is one of the great catches you'll see.
Ever.
Remember the one Butch Johnson made in the Super Bowl? Well, check this one out.
Curtis Johnson and Rick Volk were back in pretty good shape for the Dolphins. But Tony Hill made one heck of a catch.
Number 27, and he's going to remember that one for a long time.
Roger Staubach brings his team out on first down, 10 yards to go they need. Preston Pearson and Robert Newhouse line up as the setback. He's going to throw again, if he has time. Fumble the ball momentarily as A.J. Dewey knocked him down.
Number 77 just kept coming. The LSU Tiger, he had knee surgery earlier, and he's come back now. He looks better than he did as a rookie.
Good dog.
Left part of your screen, you'll see. Just took on Scott and came over the top and around the corner. Roger can't get it unloaded. I think he was looking for Hill making the crossing move.
Roger lost it, as we said, momentarily, but got it back. Staubach is sacked back to the 21-yard line. back to the 22 make it. They need 21 for a first down.
The third sack by that Dolphin defense.
A.J. Dewey, the last sacker. Draw play, Newhouse. And who is draped around him but A.J. Dewey? Helped by Rusty Chambers, but Dewey got there first.
Man, they are turned on, and I see a dazed look in the Dallas Cowboy eyes.
They're just flat defeating the offensive blockers.
Here's the draw. Look at Dewey took the inside. Nobody even could cut him off.
Pat Donovan tried, but Dewey by that time was with a full head of steam.
The sackee, huh? And the sacker.
That's the same group of cheerleaders we saw in the first half, but in different suits. It's third down, Cowboys. As Preston Pearson shifts over, and Staubach goes into the shotgun. Low snap. This time, the protection is good. Oh, what a play. The diving save by Norris Thomas. Tony Hill was open in the end zone, and he timed it perfectly.
Roger fooled around in that pocket about as long as any quarterback could possibly do it and survive. Tony Hill thought he had six. Norris Thomas really didn't. There's the low snap. Watch what Roger does and how long he moves and tries to find a little bit more room. Direct throw. Great play by Thomas.
Raphael Septien then at the 29-yard line. Make this a 39-yard effort. He's got enough. It's right in the heart. 20-6. We'll make it as the Cowboys get their second field goal. And that man, Raphael Septien. We have 9 minutes, 40 seconds left to play third quarter. Mike Ditka congratulates his kicker. Can't run against this outfit. I thought you could.
It's going to be a very interesting offensive series.
Didn't you think you could run against him?
Huh?
After looking at those film?
What's that? Yeah. Yeah.
Not today.
That's the most ragged-looking bunch of tackling I saw in a reel I ever saw. And they all admit it.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, they have, but that offense, they just got you right, bam, bam, bam. That's tough, boy. Duriel coming out with this one.
See what Henderson does this time.
Huh?
I'd like to see what Henderson does this time.
Sandy, give us Henderson.
The Dallas scoring drive took them 9 plays, 55 yards. They kept the ball 5 minutes, 20 seconds. With the second half kickoff, it's 20-6, Miami leads. Raphael Septien, Duriel Harris at the four. Dennis Thurman will get him out of bounds with some help from the kicker, Raphael Septien.
Septien's been in on 3 tackles.
Sports Spectacular presents the World Middleweight Championship between Hugo Coro and Rodrigo Valdez. And the Stuyvesant Handicap next Saturday, 4:30 Eastern Time, 3:30 Pacific Central.
That's the fellow Coro beat Rodrigo Valdez for that title, so the rematch ought to be rather bitter.
That's on the Sports Spectacular next week. First down, Dolphins at their own 32. They lead it 20-6. It's Andre Tillman, the tight end, moves over to the left side. Bob Greasy's been the quarterback all the way and still is. Delvin Williams will not have much room as Mark Washington comes up from the corner and cuts him down. The Dolphins haven't been able to run it.
Well, the Dallas defense was out of the flex that time. Looked like they had a lot more movement on it. Watch how quickly everybody starts taking shots. They're teeing off now. Delvin Williams, a great runner, but it's over this time.
Williams has carried 11 times and picked up just 3 yards. He was the NFL's leading rusher going in.
came in with 877 yards. But Greasy went upstairs what he had to in that first half, didn't he?
Dallas has an extra defensive back in. And Gary Davis and Norm Pulak for the backs for Greasy. Oh, it's almost picked off by Dennis Thurman as Greasy threw behind the intended receiver.
Big pressure by Tutal Jones and the first bad throw that Bob Greasy's made today.
Gary Cephalo is the intended receiver. Watch Tutal.
Tutal makes a pretty good move. Nugent's currency in his way as much as he can. Spins back to the inside, but that ball was just thrown behind. But it did look like it hurt the bad leg, the left knee of the quarterback. Got right back up.
Ulaj checks in. 8:37 left to play in the third quarter. Dallas trails Miami 20-6 at the moment.
Dolphins run a great screen, too. They can waggle to one side and screen to another. Greasy's great at it.
He's an artist. Dallas shifting around. Henderson moving over to one side. They don't blitz. Greasy firing for Dreel Harrison. He's got it. If the pass had been there, that would have been six.
And I'll tell you, there was nobody coming from the offside to help Dennis Thurman either. You know, Dreel, he's not the fastest fellow on his block. They said Joe Washington, the Baltimore running back, was four doors away where, in Port Arthur, Texas, where Dreel grew up, huh?
Frightening when you stop to think he's not. Roberts the kicker. Butch Johnson goes up with a hand for the fair catch, and wisely so, because the Dolphin coverage was there again. 43-yard kick. Cornelius was down there again, looking right in the eyes of Butch Johnson. It is 20-6, Miami over Dallas.
Sandy? I was talking about the receiver, and you had it on Greasy the whole time. I couldn't change. No worry, okay. Okay. Well, it was the... Okay. You want to give me Rayfield Wright, number 7-0? Working against Den Hedda. They have two penalties against the Dolphins that first half. Both were face masks, weren't they? Four of them? Yeah.
They had one holding against Langer.
Big series for the Dallas Cowboys on offense. Now they picked up a three-pointer, huh?
20-6 they trail right now. Lights are on at the Orange Bowl. They were on from the Dolphins for the Dolphins from the beginning of the game. Here's Dorsett. Flag goes down, and we're going to have holding against Dallas, I'm reasonably sure. Larry Gordon takes Dorsett down with help from Rusty Chambers.
Baumhauer, the big nose tackle, thought he was held. And the official thought somebody did it. And we thought the Miami defense was suspect, especially against the rush. I haven't seen that today.
Not at all. Those front three guys plus the linebackers have been just superb.
Only nine losses in the stadium since Shula's been here.
What is it, 55-9?
55 wins and nine losses.
It was John Fitzgerald, I think. As I mentioned to you before, sometimes we had trouble with that wireless mic.
It was Baumhauer. It was right on his nose.
In this stadium.
They are looking each other right in the eye.
It'll be 20 yards they need now as Dorsett gets the pitch back and breaks into the Miami secondary. Still stumbling. He is near a first down yardage. 8:05 left to play third quarter as Dorsett with the longest run from scrimmage of the day.
He's limping coming up. It's a good thing that Volk makes sort of a diving, scrambling tackle. Our Dorsett would have been gone like tomorrow. From the eye, the toss. That's Newhouse, number 44, in front.
Good block out in front by Burton Lawless.
Lawless really did a great job on Rusty Chambers. Now watch that tackle right there. If not, Drew might have been able to get number 33 up the sidelines.
Foley did the job. Second down now. They need just one for the first. 19-yard pickup by Dorsett. Newhouse still on his feet, got the first down. Kim Bocamper, the tackler.
He never quits. He's lunging out of that pile of players. 5'10", you know, you'd think he's overmatched, but sell him for 44. Look at the job that Big Den Herter's doing with Rayfield Wright. Watch this action right here. He just keeps going. He said he got second place in Charlie Pride's golf tournament in Albuquerque, and Charlie Pride gave him his guitar. And Newhouse said he strummed it three times and broke all the strings on it.
With a second effort.
That's right.
Ball is at the 42-yard line of Dallas now. First and 10, they've got Preston Pearson as replaced. They're set here as the end of round. Preston Pearson. And he has no place to go. Drew Pearson did well to get back as far as he did. Rusty Chambers stayed home.
Give your big nose guard, Mr. Baumhauer, number 73, an assist. Here goes Drew back on the end around. You'll see number 73 keep through, make him run so deep, the play is over.
Made him go deep, let the pursuit do the catching up, led by Rusty Chambers. Line of scrimmage now is the Dallas 37. Second down, they lost five, they need 15. Tony Hill goes wide left. 17-6 after third quarter score. Dorsett is back, by the way. Dobak has the ball not straight up in the air, but his arm was moving forward. It will be called a forward pass.
Rusty Chambers, a linebacker, fired from the backside of that 35. Watch the left part of your screen. See if you can pick up a couple of blurred 50 numbers coming in. Could be Gordon and Rusty Chambers. There's Gordon. It is Gordon. And the arm was moving, but not well.
Roger never saw him, but he felt him.
Penalty being walked off.
Flag down, yeah. Holding against number 51 on the Miami defense. That's Chambers. It'll be an automatic Dallas first down. And you might remember that one as this contest progresses. That could be a key first down.
A lot of time left in the third period, 5:47. Dallas hadn't gotten the touchdown yet.
Moved the ball up to the 42-yard line. They've had trouble on offense. They make a lot of first downs, but they haven't been able to get into the end zone very much. Not recently, at least. Fake draw. Dupree. Still on his feet and still struggling, and finally out of bounds in front of the Dallas bench by Rusty Chambers. Dallas first down, however.
About the best offensive play Dallas has run. Excellent pass protection, and Staubach really loads it up. Dupree starting out from the right side of the formation. Gets away from those tacky linebackers. That's a safe thing to do. Well thrown, well executed. The big fella this time really fought it off, didn't he?
Here it is again.
Watch the blocking. This time the rush is controlled. Super throw.
Yeah, excellent. DJ fighting for yardage, gets inside Miami territory to their 42. And Drew Pearson comes out of that backfield in motion. Hand off is Dorsett. Maybe a yard, but that's all. Stopped by Larry Gordon.
Sent Newhouse in front of Dorsett, and Newhouse gets roughed up too. Tell you that Baumhauer, Rusty Chambers and company, watch this. Newhouse goes in, he takes a lick, and Gordon tackles him from the backside. There are too many white shirts in here to call.
Dorsett now with 9 carries for 49 yards. So it'll be second down. 1 yard pickup on that one.
Last 3 weeks, it's been pretty rough for the young man out of Pittsburgh. In a lot of ways.
Yeah. Called the alarm clock.
Takes the phone off the hook.
Dorsett moves back deep now. Out of your picture. Take it to him. Ball by throwing. Tony Hill has it. A flag is down. Tony Hill still on his feet. Still going is Tony Hill. And finally steps out of bounds just near the Miami 10.
Dolphins, I believe, grab Billy Joe Dupree, the tight end. Going to be a penalty. Obviously, Cowboys would probably take that play.
I would think so.
What an effort by number 8-0, huh?
Staubach hung in there in the pocket nicely, too.
Rusty Chambers made a little contact with a tight end. Probably a lot of contact. but enough where he was caught.
Chambers is still arguing. Let's see if we can pick up Gordon McCarter.
Holding. Yeah. Number 51 defense declined.
51 was Chambers, right.
Let's see to the right of your screen now. You should see number 89 trying to get through there. They let him go once. He might have been over the 5-yard barrier. Tony Hill almost breaks the sound barrier. Boy, is he some athlete.
Superb. Think about that Stanford team that had Tony Hill and James Lofton together with Benjamin, the quarterback. I don't know how anybody ever stopped them.
Very few did.
On the 11, Newhouse bangs down to about the 6 before Kim Bocamper knocks him down. They can make a first down without scoring.
A little misdirection this time. They run away from Odor said he'll go to the right side. Left side, and Newhouse stumbles off the right side. He doesn't fumble either, though. Give him the ball, you're going to get it back.
He got 5 yards, too. We'll make it 2nd and 5 at the Miami 6. About the 6.5. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire at a sold-out Orange Bowl. 3:25 left before the end of the third quarter. This is Dorsett tackled in the backfield. Tim Foley.
And early. As soon as Drew Pearson came back, the man in motion to make the outside block, Foley started flying for the line of scrimmage. That's instinctive for a defensive back, you know it.
Foley's been there a while. He moved from cornerback to safety. And he does them both very well. Roger Staubach is 10 out of 14 now for 147 yards as Dorsett goes out and Preston Pearson comes in.
You had to boil a game down to one play with 2:48 left. I say this third down is a very large one.
And 5 they need to pick up the first. And now Roger Staubach asked for quiet and asked also for a timeout. Dallas first of this half. They'll have 2 left then.
Dallas has converted 5 of 8. Let's watch this conversation. I feel like I've seen Tom Landry more distressed this year on the sidelines than ever before.
Landry and Staubach. Tom, of course, calls all the plays for Rodgers, except those he might check off. 20-6, they're behind. Yeah. Yes, we would.
They got to get more than 3. Uh-huh. Getting 3.
Sandy, did somebody give you a list of who won the punt, pass, and kick contest? Oh, okay.
Well, I thought maybe Charles Milton won the contest. Is he entering that again?
How am I going to know that?
Maybe Milton will do it from the truck.
Okay. Thank you, sir. How are you going to handle that, Sandy, like we always do? Just pan down them? Okay. The skyline of Miami. Looking over the scoreboard. Uh-oh. Isn't there a name of the song called Moon Over Miami?
Certainly was.
You know the words?
Before my time, my folks used to sing it a lot.
Moon between the goalposts.
Big play.
Could be a new song. 3rd down, 5 yards. To go, Robert Newhouse and Preston Pearson, the setback. A draw play with nothing to it. Bob Matheson, the linebacker, made the tackle.
And then Herder helped, number 83.
Raphael Septian will come on.
See if you think anybody is surprised. Or does anything but look for this play. Chambers was filling too. Matheson, they were waiting for it.
Matheson never took his eyes off Preston Pearson. Stayed right with him. Charlie Waters on 4th and 4 now. Raphael Septien has already kicked 2 field goals. He'll try for number 3. The clock is running. 1:55 left third quarter. Stepped in from 24 yards out. Makes it 20-9.
Wouldn't you think, though, you would fake the Preston Pearson and get him out of the backfield?
I would have thought so. Stepped in, hits three in a row.
Dangerous receiver I got in that situation, which he is, and he's in my backfield. We've got to have at least two linebackers staring him right in the eye, and if I don't swing him out of there, the draw means nothing. You're right. Matheson just looked him right in the eye.
Yeah, he did. Never took his eyes off.
He was waiting for him to.
Yeah, wherever he was going.
I didn't make that very clear, but
okay.
I guess
you got 60 minutes.
You got a card?
I know. Raphael Septien has gotten the Cowboys to within 11 points now. It's 20-9.
Cowboys should be looking for a fumble now if they're really going to get back in this in a hurry.
Line drive kickoff will be fielded by Duriel Harris. Dennis Thurman made sure that he stayed down. Robert Steele made the initial contact. That's the Dallas scoring drive. 11 plays, 65 yards. They kept it a long time, but again, they only got 3 points.
Well, it's fun to see players on natural grass, isn't it?
It really is.
It's all out, full out.
And they love it. Forget tonight on CBS, what would happen if your city replaced its fire department with a private company fighting fires for profit? You'd save money, but would your house be safe? And that'll be one of the features on 60 Minutes tonight, along with the rest of that lineup you just saw. First and 10, Miami, ball at their own 31. They fake a blitz, and Brunick does fill the center. And they do blitz. Nat Moore is wide open out there with Mark Washington. He gets away from Cliff Harris, and he might be gone. Look who's chasing him. Randy White. But Nat Moore was too much.
There's a flag back down on the 28-yard line. Nat Moore can make you miss, Pat, like no receiver I've ever seen. He's only 5'9".
69 yards, but it's going to be called back for holding.
Nat Moore loves to go to that end zone. But you don't see anybody spiking balls for Sheila, do you?
You know, it looked like Randy White was actually picking up ground on Nat Moore. He was the last guy chasing him.
Greasy barely got the pass off. Cliff Harris was blitzing the safety blitz.
Let's see who it was. Leroy Harris picking up the blitz.
Fullback trying to help. Let's watch the left part of your screen, and you'll see the flying safety man. I believe that was Charlie Waters, number 41, that was blitzing.
Right.
And now Washington's missed tackle. Uh-oh, you better clean the gun and get the dogs. It's over.
Look at Randy White.
He's shaking the ground behind that boy.
Down Miami again. It has been passing down for them. But now it's Delvin Williams. And the flex gets him. The ball is loose. Miami gets it back. Current fell on it. But another flag is down.
I believe the tight end Tillman grabbed Too Tall Jones and tackled him. Oh no, a clip.
Against Miami again. Unpopular to say the least.
They're the least publicized penalized team on offense in the National Football League. They've been very error-free in that department. Who's it on? Look at this. He's tough on officials, but he's straight with them and honest with them.
He can get their attention.
And then write a good letter to the league office about how what a good job they do, you know.
Here's Bob Greasy.
That tight end may have just sort of crabbed around behind Too Tall Jones and then let him fall.
Personal foul, flipping number 67 offense, repeat first down.
That is Kuchenberg, who has moved out. Ball all the way back at the 11-yard line, and Dallas did not jump offside. Looked like they might have momentarily. No flag. And the Miami fans are up in arms about that.
Cowboy defense really has only 11 interceptions coming in, which is a low factor for them. They have nobody in the top 10 in the interception categories. This would be a good time to pull off one if they're really back in this game.
Boulos checks in. Leroy Harris comes out. Second down now. The Dolphins need 27 for a first. Ball back at their own 14. Regular defense for Dallas this time. They're at four. Greasy. Oh, for Leroy Harris. Flag is down. He bumped him. No question about it.
Mark Washington. And Duriel Harris had him by about a yard and a half.
That, of course, will be a first down, Miami.
What a pass by Bob Greasy. That was a streamlined, beautiful pass.
Defense, number 46, defense, first down.
Everybody has said Greasy can't throw it 50 yards. But I'll tell you, this is a pretty tight spiral. Take a look at it. Thrown early and pretty sharp. A little bit of contact going for the ball. Supposedly, as a defensive back, you're allowed to. But they're watching this very closely these days.
I'll say.
Oh.
24 seconds left to play in the third quarter. The Dolphins have just had a 69-yard touchdown call back because of the holding penalty. And that penalty against the Cowboys gets them back in business. Outside quickly. Duriel Harris, Mark Washington, wrestles him to the ground after he picks up three or four. Washington playing hurt a little bit. Benny Barnes has severe foot problem.
What a psychological call, though. The fellow's just committed pass interference, and now you go over and make him go one-on-one. Sandy, you want to give me He looks too old to be in PP and KO. Is he 14? Was that last one a Nat Moore? Was that Duriel or Nat that caught that last
Duriel? Duriel.
Was that Moore? No. The short.
Ladies and gentlemen, earlier today you watched the punt, pass, and kick competition, which is sponsored by the Ford Dealers of America and the NFL. The six winners here today will represent the Miami Dolphins at the AFC Division competition on December the 17th in Houston. Presenting the trophies to the area champions is Jack McCormick, Ford Division Zone Manager. First, the 8-year-old winner is Moore Young from Pahokee, Florida. The 9-year-old winner from Miami, Bill Henderson. The 10-year-old winner from Jessup, Georgia, Lee Nichols. The 11-year-old winner from Jacksonville, Florida, is Chris Gay. The 12-year-old winner from Stark, Florida, is Richie Fender. And finally, the 13-year-old winner from Pahokee, Florida, is Walter Johnson. Congratulations. And now let's send these youngsters to the division competition with a nice round of applause. One more quarter to play.
Duriel Harris has 5 catches for 49 yards. Young man out of New Mexico State over Las Cruces. I'll tell you, between he and Nat Moore, it's tough to do anything but double on the outsides.
And when you've got a fast improving Andre Tillman playing tight end, speaking of improvement, 2nd and 6. Tillman, number 87, moves over to the left side by Kuchenberg. Leroy Harris gets a blocking job in front of Delvin Williams. He has not quite got a first down. There's a scuffle going on between Harvey Martin and somebody.
Newman, I believe. Big guard Newman, and we've seen Harvey go to war up at Giant Stadium one time. Sometimes when you're frustrated, that's the way you vent it.
11:40 left in the third quarter. Scott Dierking has just scored for the Jets. They have closed to within 4. It's 28-24.
Harvey Martin just left and went over to cool it off on the bench before perhaps a penalty flies next time. Huh?
Larry Bathea took his place. They need 2 for a first. Wouldn't be surprised to see BC throw.
Oh.
Too tall Jones with the sack on Bob Greasy. He was looking for Nat Moore.
Went right over current. What's the right part of your screen? A great call, really, and Pat, you did call it. Nat Moore was cutting back to the left, a diagonal that was wide open. Suddenly, it gets to be cloudy.
Big Cloud is 6'9 and 275, and there he is.
Bernie Starter's got him playing some football today, hasn't he?
Butch Johnson stands back at the 10-yard line. Roberts. George Roberts. They try to block it. They don't. Line drive bounces. It hits a Dallas player. Butch Johnson wisely picks it up. It hit Dennis Thurman in the head. And Butch used his head.
He got out of bounds, which wasn't a bad idea either.
13 minutes, 38 seconds left to play. It's the Dolphins 20, the Cowboys 9. Disaster.
Sandy, give me Tony Hill, will you?
Yeah. Smooth one, wasn't it?
What's that?
Oh, good. Okay. Okay.
At least the hood. Is Flipper still in the tank?
Yeah. Let me see that with all the standings on. Thank you.
Yeah, I think he's still in there. I see something.
We want to isolate him.
Quick interview with him.
The Miami Dolphins leading Dallas 20-9. New England has already won today. Their record now is 8-2. Miami trying to stay just one game behind. Their record 6-3, as was Dallas going in. Tony Dorsett shifts deep. Outside Tony Hill. A couple of jukes. And Larry Gordon. And Rusty Chambers made sure.
I thought the Dolphins secondary couldn't tackle. They are very sure today. A short out, a very tough one. Tony Hill, injured or not, is very dangerous once he catches it. I'm telling you, Gordon comes over to help, and they're doing a heck of a job.
There he is, Flipper the second.
He's still there, huh? Day or night. You know, they do a lot of talking. They got recordings out now. You understand them, though, then they put you away.
I didn't get a chance to talk with him.
I'd like to interview him just once.
5-yard pickup. San Diego now 19-0 over Cincinnati. Newhouse cuts back. Stopped by A.J. Dewey.
Staubach is 11 of 15 for about 154 yards. Sounds like it should be a good day, but no touchdowns. Points, 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 huh?
That San Diego score we gave you before is now 19-0. San Diego over Cincinnati. Mike Fuller intercepted a pass by Kenny Anderson and ran it back for a touchdown, 21 yards.
Dolphins said they had a lot of trouble beating San Diego. They had to block two punts and pick up fumbles to beat that team out there.
They have a lot of big people. Third down, a very, very short yard for the Dallas Cowboy offense. Newhouse shifts twice. And Starback is going to throw it. Fumble! Bob Baumhauer on top of Roger.
Gordon picked up Dupre, and Butch Johnson from the other side of the field was wide open, but Roger had no chance to see him.
He is really upset about something.
I don't think I've seen Roger with that much emotion in a long, long time. All right.
That is serious emotion.
Fourth sack by the Dolphins, the short yardage. Well, let's see what happens right here. Roger hits it with his own knee, but he recovers.
Danny White standing back in his own end zone. High kick. Cephalo goes up with the hands with a fair catch at the 49. They'll be just inside Dallas territory as they start to operate. Roger's callback, I believe, was upset because he felt that Billy Joe Dupre was being held at the line of scrimmage. Nevertheless, the score is 20-9. The Dolphins lead.
Yo. Ha, ha, ha.
Where?
You're kidding, aren't you?
On the field?
Same to you, fella. Look at that. Get Flipper. One more time. Likes that. What was that, sausage?
Flipper the second in a tank behind the goalpost that holds 37,000 gallons.
Well, he's active, you know it.
Artificially salted water, he is.
People will turn him on, I think.
So does food. Greasy, 10 out of 16 for 163 yards. Sends Nat Moore in motion and gives the ball back to his fullback, Leroy Harris. 20-9 the score. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire at the Orange Bowl in Miami.
Dallas is liable to start really crowding the line of scrimmage now and blitzing and perhaps rolling the dice a little bit, trying to steal the ball or upset Greasy. And obviously a fellow like number 12 can take advantage of that and put another score on. It's a very careful time for the defense, but they're the ones that maybe have to win it.
Dallas record is 6-3. They're facing Washington. The Redskins 7-2 play Baltimore. Tomorrow night, Norm Bulak in the Dolphin backfield as Greasy backpedals and throws. Delvin Williams has a Dolphin first down, stopped by Charlie Waters.
Delvin Williams, who had that big 42-yarder in that shocking first quarter. Boy, what a good-looking back he is. Here are the problems that Bruni gets facing. The middle linebacker comes back, just undershoots it. Greasy waited for Delvin Williams to clear the linebacker, didn't he?
A very sharp quarterback, Bob Greasy, 33 years old now, asking for quiet. Perfect night for him with the glasses. Rain causes a problem. Today, the weather's been perfect. So is Greasy. Oh. Leroy Harris bangs just inside too tall Jones for three or four, but they still have not been able to run effectively. In the end zone, watch it develop.
Right part of your screen. Let's see the engagement. Greasy really playing this team like a Stradivarius. Look at this. Slips the fullback right inside the big tackle. Too tall tried to close it off and couldn't. And that's a 225-pound load there, too. Leroy Harris is rather stocky.
Jethro Q made the tackle. Out comes Mike Curran. In goes Wayne Moore.
Curran they obtained from the Tampa Bay team and has done an excellent job. Looks like it maybe too tall just leaned on the left side of his neck or something.
Wayne Moore, who took his place, is of course a veteran for Miami. They won't suffer too much there. Second and seven situation. 3 yard pickup on that last play.
Dolphins have only fumbled six times all year long. Careful.
Huh? That is amazing. 9:53 left to play as Greasy lofts it outside to Andre Tillman, who makes the catch in the grasp of Thomas Henderson. Another Dolphin first down.
And Henderson was running in his shadow all the way. Greasy, quick drop back. Again, Langer and company going to work. Look at this, coverage and catch. 6'5" tight end will beat you every time if he's got hands like that.
Perfectly well done. Third quarter, Los Angeles against Tampa Bay is the score you just saw. Neil O'Donohue of the Buccaneers has kicked three field goals. Frank Corral, two for the Rams, and Pat Hayden threw a 68-yard touchdown pass to Billy Waddy. Leroy Harris stopped just inside the 20 by Dede Lewis. Maybe he got one or two.
Mark Washington made the first contact, but it's a good thing Dede came along. Leroy Harris is a fullback that went 77 yards a year ago. He's got great speed, and he was heading for the outside.
He's replaced now by Bulac. 9:20 left to play. Miami Dolphins leading Dallas 20-9.
How do you get the ball away from Bob Greasy?
That's the fourth quarter score now. San Diego, Cincinnati, 19-0, Chargers. Ball's at the 20 in Dallas territory. Straight back again. Under the chase by Ed Jones and down by Too Tall Jones. Pressure two from Henderson, but Too Tall made the tackle.
Too Tall went right to work on Moore, the new tackle that came in when Current left. He was giving Current a lot to handle, too. Greasy didn't throw it and get the intentional grounding or anything, did he, though? He took his loss. Wants to stay in field goal range if he possibly can if a touchdown doesn't show up.
The situation now is third. They need 17 for a first down. Ball now back at the 29-yard line of Dallas. Andre Tillman checks out. They'll go with the three wide receivers now as Cephalo comes in. Nat Moore goes wide left in the slot. This is the top of your picture. Duriel Harris is put wide to the right. Oh. Delvin Williams. And a quick trap almost broke the six. Aaron Kyle had to make the tackle.
Cowboys hurt on the field, and I'm telling you, that was a quick trap. Langer went to one side, and Newman comes through from the other side. Henderson standing right in the hole. Langer just brushed him aside and then took care of Cole. There was nobody in the middle. The linebacker was gone. The first step he took across the line of scrimmage.
I believe it's Henderson that's hurt. Delvin Williams got that back down to the 15-yard line. And it's going to be fourth down and Eprimian without doubt. Looked like he got
hit.
Did
you see what that Langer did then? Langer took and threw Henderson down and then took Cole and buried him. Look at this.
That looked like he gets hit though. Oh, somebody kicked him in the head, his own man. Cliff Harris.
Is that Harris coming on the side? Yep, his old man kicks him with his foot.
Yeah.
That is Cliff, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
You got that shot there, Sandy? Oh, look at that. Delvin hit that hole. Who's that left guard there? Is that... who is that at left guard?
Right here?
Yeah. Who's at left guard? Is that Kuchenberg?
It's supposed to be Newman. But it doesn't look like it, does it?
I guess it is 64. It doesn't look like a forward, does it? Mm-mm.
Little. He was a trapper.
It is Little. Okay, yeah. It's a trapper. Yeah, that makes sense. Golly.
Who's he, out, huh?
Who is he burying there? The safety
man? Randy Hughes, yeah.
Yeah, we're having a gamble now, you know, up there all the time.
The preceding announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Football League.
What's the replay of this now? Watch Little pull from the right to the left and take care of the safety man Hughes. Langer throws Henderson down, and he's kicked by his own man. And there goes Delvin Williams.
Garrow Reprimian from about 33 yards out. Don Strock holding. Got it.
That's a nail.
Garrow's third of the day. Septien has three also. But the Dolphins have two touchdowns to go with Garrow's three.
You say something? Were you pointing at something? Oh. Okay. That's a nail there, baby.
16 and 7. 16. 7 more.
23. They got to get a fumble there.
Mm-hmm.
They got to get a special team lift or something. You know what?
Two real quick ones.
Don Grease, he just keeps...
Okay.
What a call against that, huh? They showed awfully early with it.
Mm-hmm.
Came up there and sat right there and then stayed with it, huh? Bet you that was a... was that an audible? I didn't see any. I don't remember the...
I don't either. Garrow Yeprimian's third field goal makes it the Dolphins 23, Dallas 9. Garrow's kick. Grounder. Handled by Burton Wallace. Who was knocked down over at the 36-yard line, lost the football momentarily, and is now fighting to get it back. The NFL on CBS next Sunday. The Giants at Washington, Tampa Bay at Detroit, Atlanta at New Orleans. Dallas at Green Bay, and by the way, the starting time for that game has been changed to 3 o'clock at Milwaukee County Stadium. St. Louis will be at San Francisco, Chicago at Minnesota. But again, the Green Bay-Dallas game will start at 3 o'clock in Milwaukee.
7:35 left, and you need two touchdowns.
Luke Pearson split wide to the left and Tony Hill to the right, and Roger Staubach is just about going to have to throw on every play. Screen Dorsett breaks away from Dewey. Tony Dorsett finally goes down at the 42-yard line in Miami territory by Rick Vogt.
Boy, it looked like Dorsett was just going to draw the hypotenuse of the right triangle, go straight diagonally across the field. Here's the screen setting up. Dorsett going to your right now. He runs by about four people that think they're potential tacklers.
Herbert got out in front of him, got a good block. So did John Fitzgerald.
Boy, I'd say Rafferty got one, too. Looked like he might have been clipped by Vogt and barely went down.
Dick Anderson, former all-pro safety man for the Dolphins, looking on. He just retired. He had about 5 knee operations, didn't he?
Well, he's a sun safety man.
Staubach is going deep for Drew Pearson. He could not quite turn it on. Curtis Johnson back there with Drew, who's caught one pass today to keep his consecutive game streak alive at 55.
Looked like Roger thought Drew was going to stay straighter on it, and Pearson had to sort of swerve to get away from making contact with Curtis Johnson. Roger threw that one a long way.
About 55 yards. Rafferty just checked in with the play information from Tom Landry.
We haven't seen the crossing pattern with Drew Pearson yet today, have we?
No.
Where they clear out and bring him under.
When they start him in motion. 6:41 left to play. Score is Miami 23, the Cowboys 9. That game's in the fourth quarter. Denver 28, the Jets 24. Denver had been ahead one time, 28-7. The draw play is a fake to Dorsett. Starbuck looking. Throw.
Oh.
Tony Hill had a first down for a while and then almost got away from it. He does get out of bounds to stop the clock with 6:29 left to play.
Great throw by Roger Staubach. He wanted to go up to Drew Pearson earlier, and he was well covered. Roger just scooted out and threw it like a single wing tailback. Got it to him, and him can move.
Him had a first down by about 3 yards and went back. So he lost it at one time, but eventually got out of bounds, and Dallas moves the sticks. 6:29 left to play. Not too many folks leaving the Orange Bowl. Their Dolphins lead 23-9. Ball to the Miami 30. Dupree. Heard it back by Rusty Chambers and finally slung and flung to the ground, and now he is protesting.
They're beginning to control the line of scrimmage. The Cowboys are beginning to straighten them up there and not letting the penetration take place. Rogers now 14 of 19. For 196 yards, but no cigars, they say. He hadn't gotten the touchdown yet.
6 minutes now left to play. Dallas record was 6-3 starting. The Giants lost, so they're 5-5. Philadelphia won, so they're 5-5. Dallas loses, they will be 6-4. With Washington to play Baltimore tomorrow night. Newhouse and Dorsett ship. And now Newhouse gets back. Second, they need about a yard. Outside, Dorsett with a couple of blockers in front of him. Dorsett to the 10. To the 8. Larry Gordon made the tackle.
Den Herter read the play perfectly when he came off the line. Number 83 did. There's just not a darn thing he could do about it. Watch the left of your screen, 83. They sort of let him through, and he sees it, and he says, I'll go out there and chase. Forget it. This mean motor scooter, when he gets it going, can really do it.
At the 9, it'll be first and goal, Dallas. That's where they mark it. 5 minutes, 5 seconds left to play. Roger Staubach sets his offensive line. He'll drop. They pick up the blitz. Staubach had it in the hands of Billy Joe Dupree, and he knocked it away. Rusty Chambers, I believe, got a hand on it and knocked it out of the grasp of Billy Joe.
Great play by number 51. He's in the left lower part of your screen now. Dorsett gets a good block for Staubach. Ball is really rifled. That's just an excellent defensive play.
Gordon just got the arm in there in time. A 1 yard run by Ricky Bell has got the Buccaneers within 4 of Los Angeles. They have 13:41 left to play in that game.
You don't think McKay wants that one, do you?
I would guess he might. Less than 5 left to play. Second down and goal, Dallas. Makes a couple of times, throws, touchdown. Dupree will spike it in the end zone, and Dallas, the touchdown pass from Roger Staubach to Billy Joe Dupree.
The 6th catch for Billy Joe Dupree. He really kept them in this game early when nobody else seemed to have the machinery oiled up. A great throw by Roger, again on the run, being chased. Hello, leaping spike.
That makes it 23-15. We've got 4:44 left to play, and what a finish. This is going to be something.
Dallas smells the scent, huh?
Raphael Septien makes it 23-16. He has 3 field goals, and so does Epremian. Dallas has gotten their first touchdown on a pass from Staubach to tight end Billy Joe Dupree.
A lot of time left. It's a lot of time left. Greasy's got to run the ball a little bit.
I could use a refill. Can you?
It's getting to be a tough game now. Playing both ways is rough.
These yours? those yours?
Oh, gosh.
Don't forget those.
Red Eye, are you still thinking about an interview? This game's going to go on and on.
We haven't heard any scores on Detroit, Minnesota all day, have we? Did we ever get Did we get one? I don't. Oh, it was? Okay. Dallas touchdown with 4:44 left to play makes it 23-16.
Like Miami's deploying for a possible onside kick here. Nope.
In the direction of Duriel Harris at the three. A flag is down. Harris is also out of bounds.
We'll call Rick Volk for throwing an elbow, making a block out of that kickoff return team.
Dennis Thurman herded him out of bounds, and something happened way back here about the 40-yard line, way away from the ball.
I think Rick Volk threw an elbow on a block, wrapped somebody high on the side of the head, and that's going to start Shula's team deep, and this is a big drive for him. He knows it.
There's the conference with Gordon McCarter. Personal foul. It's against Miami. The event you might have missed is Minnesota beat Detroit today 17-7. Grand target and a touchdown pass to Sammy White and Chuck Foreman. A one-yard run.
It's going to get a little bit tacky now because Greasy has got to run the football a little bit. Destroy that clock if he can. Not give the ball back to Staubach. It looks like Dallas offense has come back out.
They were slow out of the blocks.
Unnecessary roughness, number 21.
Rick Bolt.
Kicking team. Declined.
Declined by Dallas.
I've got to toss that one around for a minute.
Me too.
Well, it happened up here about the 37-yard line, so it might have been from point of foul. They might have cost him a few yards if they had taken it from where it was marked off, huh? Will you settle for that?
Awesome. Yeah. Leroy Harris and Delvin Williams, the running backs behind Greasy. Andre Tillman is number 87, the tight end. It's Delvin Williams. There's not much room to operate. Bob Prunig led the Dallas defense. Keep in mind that Dallas had to use a timeout earlier, so they only have two left.
It's a time when Miami cannot afford to be too conservative, but they still must at the same time stay straight and basic. It's tough to run against this team. We've said before, you really don't make a living running at this team.
Well, it would appear right now they're planning to throw as Norm Bulosh has checked in at fullback in place of Harris. Don Landry. And Don Shula. The two winningest active coaches in his business today. They rank number 4 and 5 on the all-time list. Shula's 4, Landry's 5. The chase by Tutal Jones, and it gets him again. Somebody's fired him up.
Ernie Stotner says, I keep getting his attention. And Tutal has gotten his third sack of the afternoon. Fourth sack of the afternoon. Tutal. He just goes right by. Current. I think everybody was covered at the same time. I don't believe Greasy wanted to throw it much.
Roger Staubach on the phone in between Jim Myers and Tom Landry. Gary Davis goes in. Along with Cephalo, it'll be 3rd and 15 after that sack by Tutal.
3.5 minutes left. Clock is running.
Dolphins lead 23-16. Bulosh comes out. Williams comes out. There will be one setback. Miami takes a timeout.
Pretty smart, though. They used a lot of time on that clock that time. And I heard Shula say, we're all right.
3 minutes and 14 seconds left to play. The Dolphins 23. The Dallas Cowboys 16. Overtime?
Maybe. Ha 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 ha.
Let's see now. If we go into overtime, what happens to 60 Minutes?
What happens to that local franchising firehouse story you had? Everybody should have their own firehouse.
For profit. It's like being a bounty hunter.
It is. I won't come out of your side of town. You got to give me an extra bonus.
Put a lot of arsonists back to work.
Let's see what happens here. Harvey, give me Harvey Martin. Sandy, my man. Give me Harvey Martin, huh? Nickeling.
Yeah. Landry and Myers looking on from the sideline. Their team trailing 23-16. 3:14 left to play. The handoff is straight ahead to Gary Davis. But the defense for Dallas did their job. Randy White made the tackle on that last play.
Shula is holding on, right?
Tonight on CBS, don't forget, 60 Minutes. Followed by All in the Family, Alice, Kaz, and Alice, the Cowboys.
60 Minutes, they're talking about franchise firehouses. You can open up your own. Is that true?
For profit. Put them out for profit. That'll be on 60 Minutes tonight. That solid Sunday night lineup on CBS. George Roberts is the Dolphin punter. Butch Johnson for Dallas back by himself. Took a long time. High kick that sort of turns around backwards and bounces back. The ball will be down. Miami touched it in their own territory. Back about the 45-yard line. Just a 27-yard punt by Roberts. And a break, I guess you could say, for Dallas. Tom Landry talking to Staubach with Mike Ditka just behind him.
And he's got 2:20 on the clock, so in 20 seconds he's going to get a free timeout if he can get a couple of plays off that he wants to run.
And then he has two left after that. The Dolphins broke on top. They were ahead 17-0 before we could get our breath. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire at the Orange Bowl in Miami. Sold out. And nobody's left. Tony Dorsett and Robert Newhouse stand behind Staubach. Big draw. Billy goes to three wide open again. The fumble. And the Dolphins have it. Norris Thomas brings it out, and Dorsett takes him down from right behind. He lost the ball, but he was already out of bounds. The Dallas Cowboys are out on the field, on the far side of the field, saying the ball should have been blown dead.
There are about 40 players on the field now. Two offensive units, two defensive units.
Let's see what the call is.
Dupre had the completion, it looked, it appeared to.
It is Miami's football.
We'll try to rerun it very quickly. Roger hitting Billy Joe Dupree coming across. He's been great all day. Carried it rather loosely, and well, that's a close call.
Tim Foley hit him.
Watch Dorsett. Catch number 41 from behind right here.
Dorsett took him down. It's a first down Miami with 2 minutes and 3 seconds left to play. What a break for the Dolphins. The handoff to Leroy Harris. And that'll be the last play before both coaches are notified that there are 2 minutes left to play.
You know, we're talking about those double playoff spots now that 9-7 records will look pretty good for a lot of teams. This league is really tough.
I'll say. Don't forget the Sports Spectacular next week. The World Middleweight Championship between Hugo Coro and Rodrigo Valdez, as well as the Stuyvesant Handicap. That's for three-year-olds and up. Seattle Slough will be making his final appearance. Farewell. That's on the Sports Spectacular next week at 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time, 3:30 Central and Pacific.
How close was the fumble on Billy Joe Dupree? I thought he had lost the ball before he hit the ground. I thought it was a fumble, didn't you?
I wasn't sure he ever had possession.
He took a couple of pretty good giant strides.
Yeah, he did. Waters talking with Landry.
Well, Miami's been doing that all year. Anytime anybody wanted to make a mistake and take a little too long punting or fumble a football, the Dolphins have eaten them up. They are the best takeaway team in the National Football League, and you give this guy the ball very often, Mr. Greasy, and he can just pack it up.
Dallas has four turnovers now, Miami none.
Look at him, he acts like he's going to his office. like he had a briefcase on his hand. It was his helmet.
Sandy Grossman has been our most able director, as always.
He loves dolphins and porpoises, too, doesn't he, Sandy? Shoots them all the time.
I didn't know that.
Naturalist.
Charles Milton III is the producer. Takes care of everything. It'll be second down for the Dolphins. Not much time left to play. New England has already won. They beat Buffalo to up their record to 8-2. If Miami wins, they will stay just one game behind, 7-3. Miami plays Buffalo next week, by the way.
Miami has a pretty tough schedule down the road, too. They play New England again, too, don't they?
Houston plays New England next week. That's no picnic. Long count for Greasy. He gets to Delvin Williams. He will not get the first down.
Uh-oh.
Ball was knocked loose. Dallas reacted momentarily like they thought they might have had it. Ed Newman on the bottom of the pile recovered it.
Ball popped to the surface out of that pile of players.
Timeout Dallas. They have one left.
Delvin Williams is shaken up, huh?
That's a fourth quarter score now, 23-16. As Corral has kicked another field goal. This one 32 yards.
I'm a believer in Don Shula's philosophy on football. They are really well prepared. I don't think you can be in a better position as a football player than to play for Shula.
Giants at Washington, Tampa Bay, Detroit, Atlanta, New Orleans next Sunday. Don't forget to stick around for scores and highlights after this game. Dallas will be at Green Bay next week. And by the way, again, that starting time has been changed to 3 o'clock at County Stadium in Milwaukee, St. Louis and San Francisco, and Chicago at Minnesota. Here we have a third down situation. Our score is the same as the Ram Tampa Bay score, 23-16.
Dallas looks like they've almost kicked that lethargic pose they had when they've come around the last couple of weeks. They've had 10 days to get ready for this game, though. You know, it's looked like the Dolphins have had the extra days.
Bob Greasy checks back in. You know, there's a bunch of interested and at the moment happy Redskins watching this game. Their record is 7-2. Dallas would drop back to 6-4 if it stays like this. Gary Davis and Jim Braxton, the running backs. Greasy gives to Davis. He won't get the first down.
You think Billy Kilmer's watching? You think there's you guys around the fire just watching?
Around the fire?
Probably.
Errol Yeprimian as again. The referee starts the clock. The Dolphins do a little Sunday afternoon stroll to come into punt formation, and the clock is going. Dallas has one timeout left. A minute and 20 seconds left to play as Landry.
Try to block it.
Unless you try to block it or try to set up a return. They haven't had much success with the return. The Dolphins look like they might take enough time to take a penalty. There are only 5 seconds left now on the 30-second clock.
Shula's done it all. He's taken safeties in the end zone, you know, to let you have nothing left at the end.
You know, that wouldn't be a bad thought right now, would it?
Except the end zone's a long way off. Might get winded, just run all the way back here.
I don't know what kind of athlete Roberts is, but
he better be a good one.
He'd take off back there, and then he'd get his free kick.
I'd be thinking that.
Delay of game.
But then, if the Cowboys did manufacture something, they could win.
Or if he fumbled, huh?
Yeah.
Landry might tackle him if he ran back there.
Dallas has that one timeout left. Butch Johnson is standing back deep for the Cowboys. Roberts. The Miami punter. They're going to try to block it. Long count. They're not going to make it. This time he hangs it high, and Butch goes up with the hand. Fair catch. He'll be 84 yards away from a touchdown. Good kick that time by Roberts.
And 54 seconds of X's and O's. see what Tom Landry is going to orchestrate now. You have some set plays. Maybe you'll have a hurry up, no huddle for two or three in a row.
I would imagine back to the 16-yard line. That's where they'll have to operate from. The Dolphins broke quickly on top, and they've stayed that way all day. Dallas is at Green Bay next week. Packers lost today to Philadelphia. Green Bay's record is now 7-3. Philadelphia's 5-5. Roger Staubach in the shotgun. It'll be a three-man rush. No blitz. Pump. Dorsett sees it fly through his fingers. So it will be second down. He didn't have much room anyway.
He had a lot of company. A couple of buildings moved over, sat up right next to him. Where is Tony Hill? Is number 80 in the game?
He'll be split wide to the right.
Shula would like to put him under lock and key.
Tony Hill and Drew Pearson, the wide receivers. 23-16 the score with 48 seconds left to play. Pearson comes wide left, and there is T. Hill. Shotgun with Preston Pearson back beside Roger. For Drew. Out of bounds. The coverage was good. Tom Landry looks a little bit bewildered at the moment. Gerald Small on the coverage, and Shula alongside Bill Arnsparger.
Arnsparger's defense. And they have played it. They are tired out there now, the Dolphins are, but they put their pads on and they have really hunched it up and played some football.
Clock has stopped with 41 seconds left to play now. Cowboys have one more timeout. This time Drew Pearson goes right and Tony Hill comes left. Excuse me. Protection is good. Or was for a while and still is. Billy Joe Dupree has it, hit him on the kneecap and bounce away. Staubach did a heck of a job, but Rick Volk on the coverage.
Dupree's had such a game. He had 9 catches before the catch and the fumble. That one just hit him on the boards.
It'll be a fourth down situation coming up with 33 seconds left to play. Rafferty with the message from Landry. And Roger Staubach, you can see him discussing things with Drew Pearson. You'd have to think that would be the direction he would look in this clutch situation.
Hardest thing to overcome are turnovers. The fumbles, they will just literally eat up a good offensive team.
Here it is. Fourth down, 10 yards to go. Strike. Preston Pearson breaks one tackle. Preston out to the 50-yard line before down he goes, and they're asking for that last timeout. 22 seconds left to play. What an athlete, Preston Pearson.
And every catch he makes is a pressurized situation. None could have been more than this. He's swinging out of the backfield. Roger never let him get out of his sight. What a strike. Now they close in.
Not over yet. Norris Thomas finally made the tackle just inside Miami territory. They have that much time left, but they have no more timeouts left. They trail by 7. Yeah.
What a comeback that is.
Okay. Okay. Okay, give me the goodbye card, would you please? Give me the goodbye card, please. Okay.
I'd run a deep corner pattern. I'd go with 80.
Twenty-two seconds left to play in this contest.
Pat, you almost have to run some kind of a deep corner pattern to get enough yardage to get close and stop the clock. Obviously, Miami's thinking the same thing.
Jet Denver score is now 31-28. The Jets, Matt Robinson, a touchdown pass to Wesley Walker. That is the second touchdown pass for Robinson today, and he's done a job and replaced Richard Todd. Low snap. A flag goes down. Staubach throws wide left. Billy Joe Dupree tiptoes out of bounds.
Gordon, the linebacker, was lined up offsides. Incredible.
Looked like it might be a Dallas first down. That play took 8 seconds.
Gordon just had his helmet over the line of scrimmage. They've doubled up on the receivers all the way across, and I don't think number 50 thought about where he was. See, here he is. Bottom of the frame there.
Offside, number 50 on the defense, declined, first down.
First down, Dallas with 14 seconds left to play. But keep in mind, they have no timeouts as Burton Lawless comes in with the play from Landry.
Landry's something, isn't he? Still just stalking the sidelines.
Line of scrimmage at 39 in Miami territory. Time for maybe two more plays. Dallas from the shotgun, the rush is on. Staubach gets away from a couple, throws out of bounds. Intended for Billy Joe Dupree, couldn't hang on. 6 seconds left to play. 2 8-second plays, the last two.
Well, there had to be a moment when Roger thought, I've got to put it away and run it. You know, can I make it all the way to the end zone? Because that's what he had to think about.
This has got to be some sort of an alley-oop in the end zone. Just throw it up in the air and hope somebody comes up with it.
It's too tall play offense, huh?
Be a good chance to use him, wouldn't it? I bet you they haven't thought about that.
It's a lot easier to get ideas up here than it is down there.
And, of course, the pressure on that Miami front three. Vernon Herter, Dewey, and Baumhauer. And the pressure on the Dallas offensive line as well to give him time. He'll have the time. Free throw.
It's intercepted, I believe.
It is intercepted at about the 3-yard line. Charlie Babb came up with it. The Dolphins have defeated Dallas. Final score, 23-16.
There's Langer.
It'll be a jubilant Miami locker room. Packed house in the Orange Bowl. Had a good day, didn't they? For Tom Brookshire. This is Pat Summerall saying so long for the, from the Orange Bowl in Miami. The Dolphins beat the Cowboys 23-16. We now take you to CBS Sports Control in New York.
You know how close that ball was clearing through there? That baby was whistling. That's the best game I've seen Tuttle Jones play.
Yes, in a long time, since the end of last year. Thank you.